Stop by Fishing Hole Archery and Angling today.
For some of the nation's premier programs, last season was nothing but frustration and humiliation. A year later, the swagger is back. Wisconsin has already matched last season's win total and has Badger fans thinking Rose Bowl. Under old school coach Joe Paterno, today's opponent, Penn State has reinvented themselves after back-to-back losing campaigns. There's a resurgence in Manhattan, where an undefeated Kansas State aims for their fifth 11-win season in the last 6 years. Today, they face Big 12 rival Colorado. Out west, only the winner of the Oregon State-UCLA clash will continue their restoration. Plus, former NFL coach Chan Gailey has Georgia Tech believing they can win the ACC crown. In their way, Wake Forest. It's a football revival next on ABC Sports.
And welcome to Times Square Stadium here in New York City in the Hartford pregame show. John Saunders alongside of Terry Bowden. Now, back-to-back losing seasons for Joe Paterno. I had some people saying the game had passed him by. Not so fast, obviously. But if he looks back to last year against Wisconsin, worst offensive performance ever for one of his teams.
Yeah, Joe Paterno likes winning too much not to change, but he opened up too late last week against Iowa in the fourth quarter, down 22 points. He's got to give the ball to quarterback Zach Mills from the get-go, throw it to these talented receivers, and see how good this 5-0 Wisconsin team is.
In the Big 12, throw is probably not a word we're going
to
hear a lot of.
These two teams, they run the football to win. That's just what they do. Kansas State, the difference in last year's 6-6 team, and this year's, they make big plays on offense. Look for little man Darren Sproles to make big plays from the tailback position.
All right, we already have an upset in the making in the SEC. Rex Grossman, erratic today, has a couple of touchdown passes, but this one is picked off by Matt Greer of Ole Miss. Takes it 24 yards for the touchdown. 17-14 is the lead. We, of course, will keep you up to date with all of the games, and we'll see you at halftime. Right now, enjoy the first half.
Ralphie leads the Buffaloes out. It's the grand entrance for the defending champions of the Big 12. It's a beautiful day in Boulder, Colorado. Kansas State and Colorado opened the Big 12 season a year ago. The Big 12 North. Colorado 7-1. They won the tiebreaker. K-State a disappointing 3-5. Determined to claw their way back to the top. Welcome everybody. For the old quarterback Gary Danielson, I'm Brett Musburger. Great to have you along with us. It's going to be a tough football game. What's going to decide it, Gary?
Brent, you know, these are two of the most physical football teams in college football, but it's not just going to be who's the toughest. I look at this game as a chess match. One team is using two quarterbacks, and I'm sure Gary Barnett from Colorado will try to exploit that, try to get him the number two. Colorado's going with their number two quarterback, Robert Hodge, and I'm sure Bill Snyder will put 8 and 9 men in the box to try to force him to throw the football game. It's a chess match, but you know, both teams have some pretty good chess pieces. Colorado has Chris Brown, and in Terrence Newman for Kansas State, we might be seeing the best piece, chess piece, in college football.
Oh, I would agree with that. What a fine defensive back Terrence Newman is. So when we come back, we'll take a closer look at Mr. Newman, the most dangerous man on the field today.
The Hartford Pregame, brought to you by The Hartford. Always thinking ahead. We'll be back with the kickoff after these messages.
He's the most versatile player in college football. Some know him as the Big 12 100-meter champion. Others know him simply as the Big 12 scoring machine. Through four games, the Kansas State Blur has scored four different ways. As a wide receiver, a punt returner, a kick returner, and a blocked extra point. Today, Terrence Newman looks to score one more time as Kansas State opens its Big 12 season in Boulder. He'll be back deep to receive the opening kickoff. Number 4, Terrence Newman. How will Colorado handle him? Let's go now to Jackaroo with Coach Gary Barnett.
All right, Coach, how do you shut down or at least limit the impact that Terrence Newman can have on this game?
You don't give him a chance. You try to keep from giving him the ball, either kicking it to him or throwing it in his direction. You just don't want to let a guy like that beat you.
How about the win today? Will that help or hurt you?
I don't know. I don't think it's going to hurt us.
Good luck, Coach.
Thank you, Jack.
There is the breeze that Jack referred to in his question to Coach Barnett. It will be at Colorado's back. They win the flip. They defer. So now Mariscal will kick it off. A strategy practiced earlier this week over and over was to pooch punt short of Newman. But Gary, I think you agree with me that with a wind at the back, Mariscal might try to drive this one out of the end zone.
The altitude, too, should be able to get it out of there.
He slipped. It's on the ground. Newman handles it on the mistake. Picks his way to the 15, cuts to the hole, to the 30, 35, got the corner, and he's out beyond midfield. Great field position as Mariscal slips on the opening kickoff, and Newman brings it back 52 yards.
Strategy, 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 and all of a sudden a slip of the foot. Watches just as he approaches the ball, his left foot, his plant foot, just goes, and there it is, and that gives him the opportunity, a divot, a slip, and Newman gets his hands on his ball, and boy, does it go.
L. Roberson under center. Great field position for Roberson's first series. He'll call the play right at the line of scrimmage. He'll have two wide receivers off to the right. Darren Sproles splits now. They go back in the shotgun, and there's the penalty. They ran the clock out. Roberson makes a mental blunder to start this game. That's first and 15. That's inexcusable starting a football game when you come off the sideline like that. Roberson has got to pay attention to the clock.
Remember, this is Kansas State's first road game of the year, and they had 12 penalties in their win against USC.
Hand signals of the play. Travis Wilson gives him a fullback now because first and 15 is a lot different than first and 10. Backed up to the 48-yard line. Roberson brings him to the line, and they'll set the eye now. Motion to the right gives him a slot man on the move. They want to see how the defense reacts. They'll run Sproles right behind the fullback, short of the 40-yard line. So let's take a closer look at L. Roberson and keep this in mind. He will be operating with a short leash today. They will turn to number 5, Mark Dunn, in a heartbeat if he can't get it done. Roberson, known as a better runner than a passer, but he has not thrown an interception this season. Coach Snyder will put it up early, maybe right now on 2nd down and 9. Single back. They flex the tight end. Motion him to the left in an H-back formation. They let him lead the way, and Sproles will not get the job done as Corey Missoni cleans it up. Number 12 that time. Our Alamo starting lineup. Sproles will carry the load. We have seen that already. Wilson will be in and out of the lineup depending on whether or not they use two tight ends. They'll use an 8-man front defensively for the Buffaloes with Sneed and Missoni, the two safeties, moving up. That will leave those corners, Strickland and Jackson, isolated man-to-man. They must hold up to make this defense work. Now it is 3rd down and 10. Roberson eyes that unusual defensive set. And again, he changes up. The clock comes down to 5 seconds on him. He's got to hurry again on 3rd and 10. Gets protection, and he'll take off, but he'll be short of the first down. Colorado spies on him, and he couldn't get it done as Sam Wilder, number 90, the sophomore from Dallas, cleans up on him.
Good changeup for Vince Okru that time. Colorado defensive coordinator went with the nickel package against L. Roberson, confused him a bit, and then Sam Wilder cleans up on him, basically almost a sack.
In effect, K-State wastes that great return by Newman. And it was that mistake to put him at 1st and 15. Running into the breeze, fair catch, a signal for inside the 10-yard line. So that will be lousy field position, but perhaps there was a violation that'll help Colorado here because there is a penalty flag down and the neutral, that 2-yard measurement that you have to stay out of when somebody signals for the fair catch or is fielding a punt, may or may not have been violated.
McCoy was signaling for the fair catch for Colorado. And there's
for the
signal.
Opportunity to catch the kick.
And that's a 10-yard penalty, and that is huge.
Foul,
when you make a fair catch down inside the 10-yard line, and Snyder now is talking to Roberson about that delay of game penalty and what he's looking at out there.
McGill, number 8, was the guy who went behind thinking the ball might land on the ground where he had to down it, and the fair catch signal worked, and that's a real important 10 yards right there.
Snyder continues to confer with his quarterback over there on the sideline about this defense that they're looking at. Robert Hodge with Craig Oaks quitting the team. And how often do you hear of a captain ever walking out on a team when he's due to start their next game? But here is Hodge now, and he needs a comfort zone. He's got to settle in. They burned his redshirt season a year ago because he wanted to play. He was recruited by Nebraska, elected to come here to Colorado. They'll run that I formation ISO. Keep the clock running. Brown gets the first carry. And here's our Alamo Rent-A-Car starting lineups. Follow number 33, folks. Brandon Drum, as good a blocking fullback as there is, out of Alaska. He'll lead the way for Chris Brown. And paging Mr. Drum is Terry Pierce, number 56. What a great battle that's going to be. Outstanding corners. Colorado's strategy is to run Newman off, not to throw at him. But they say Randy Jordan looks like he's a good one. Second down and 8 now for the Buffaloes. Play fake. Hodge rolls. He's open. Underneath. Short of the first down because of a fine tackle that time. They would not let him out that time because of Terry Pierce, number 56.
The dink and dunk game of Colorado. That's what they will try to do all day.
Here's the offensive line, the heart of the game plan. And Lucier, number 78, the transfer from Northwestern, will move over to center for a time. Buckle up your chin strap, fellas, from K-State. They're coming right at you. Now it is third down and short. There's that eye. Follow Mr. Drum. He could lead the way on 3rd and 2. Here they come. Drum leads. Brown got the first down, and the Alaskan Assassin paves the way.
Both teams pride themselves in being physical up front. We saw Colorado when they made their run at the end of the big last year when they won that Big 12 championship. Up front, they go right at you. Drum, Brown, the offensive line is very physical. And really the only big difference I see from a year ago is the big tight end isn't there that really helped them run wide.
Jeremy Bloom is in as a receiver, wide left, run back. Brown breaks a tackle, gets to the safeties, and makes his way just shy of midfield. A 17-yard run for Brown. And Brown now with 3 carries has 24 yards.
6'3", 220 pounds, great balance, great confidence. He knows that when he gets his hands on the ball, he's going to fall forward and believes, like his nickname, Mr. Touchdown, Chris Brown.
He gets a break now. Purify checks in. Bobby Purify, fine receiver. He's your eye back. Drum still sets right ahead of him. The strategy you can see from Colorado, keep the clock moving. Reduce this game. They're an underdog. Let's check in with John Saunders on the Iowa update against Purdue. John.
For Brett, the Burger King update, you can see the score. Purdue sitting up 28-24, about a minute left in the game. Brad Banks goes 7 yards to Dallas Clark, who could not be more wide open. It turns out to be the game-winning touchdown, and Iowa now 5-1. Ole Miss, meanwhile, has the victory over Florida. Rex Grossman picked off 4 times in that one, Brett.
Down now, and Hodge rolls right, moves the pocket underneath the Drum, the fullback. Short of the first down. I believe the head linesman is going to mark it about a yard short. So Drum figures to be in this game plan, circling out as a receiver as well as a lead blocker. This is a very well-coached Colorado football team. Gary Barnett and offensive coordinator Sean Watson are moving the ball. 3rd down and 1 now, and you can see what the strategy is with Hodge. Move the pocket to the right for Barnett. Move it back to the left. Keep him on the run. Don't let him sit stationary as a target. He's better on the move. They offset the eye now with Drum over there. Bobble on the snap. Hodge comes back to the pocket. Goes down the middle for the touchdown. To the 1-yard line. It'll be 1st and goal. Derek McCoy. And how's that for a youngster who's not supposed to be a gunner? 41 yards as they probe the middle.
Gary Barnett knows that he's going to have to steal a couple of big plays with this quarterback. The running game's going 3rd and run. A little moat coming.
inside. McCoy comes in on the crack and then goes, and there's no way you're going to catch him. Bobby Walker's in pursuit, but Hodge, 3 for 3 in the football game. 3 perfect throws.
Gary Barnett and Sean both told us yesterday they thought they could attack the safeties. Walker was in full pursuit. Now you would expect Drum to lead the way. Hit Brown. I don't believe he got it. Now he does. Second effort. Touchdown, Colorado. You cannot stop Brown. He is perhaps the most powerful runner in the college game today. He is something. All muscle.
Well, he looked like he was stopped early, and then it looked like Kansas State let up here. Stopped, wrapped up, and then where's everybody else? Just one corner there, a safety to make the play, and he falls into the end zone.
Now Patrick Brome makes it 7-0. The Buffaloes, an underdog at home, strike first because of this perfect throw from Hodge to McCoy, his go-to wideout. 7-0 Buffaloes.
A shift can change a person, a life, the world, or it can simply change the way you move through it.
What have you been up to, Mr. Moneybags?
It's okay. I put it on the credit card.
Those interest charges are gonna get us.
Don't worry, it's our new Capital One No Hassle Card.
The Capital One No Hassle Card has the nation's lowest long-term fixed rates, $0 fraud liability, and no telemarketing.
What's in your wallet?
Introducing 3 grilled favorites on 1 sizzling skillet. Fajita chicken, shrimp, and barbecued ribs. Chili's new fajita trio.
Hi.
How you doing? What? You hungry, boy?
Need a new way to wax? Introducing Eagle One Waxes You Dry. Just wash, spray it on a wet car, and dry to an amazing shine. Waxes You Dry from Eagle One.
Fortune 500 companies outsource with Kinko's every day.
Glenn Close.
The president's plane has been hijacked.
Harrison Ford.
I'm not leaving without my family.
Air Force One. Tonight at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
A look at our Nissan Drive summary, and it was a thing of beauty as Brown scores the touchdown and Hodge goes 3 of 3 for 54 yards. Gary Danielson, you made a great point during that commercial break about Mariscal and that divot down there.
Yeah, it's right next to the ball. Actually, Mariscal has moved it over, but there is still a divot.
This time he does get under it. Newman is about 5 deep, and he's going to take a knee, and it'll come out on the 20. Well, Gary, I know you had a chance to talk to Robert Hodge, and you asked him about the offense against Kansas State.
We have to play fast. We have to be a physical team. Kansas State's defense is great. They have a lot of talent, and we have to just go right at them.
What was your feeling about Hodge when you talked to him, Gary?
I thought he was more nervous during the interviews than he was about playing the game. And that happens when you first get thrown in there. The 2 weeks of practice has really helped him settle down.
Illegal block in the back on the return team. 10-yard penalty. It'll be first down.
Now, that's an interesting penalty because they took a knee in the end zone. That means that illegal block came before he made up his mind and killed the play. So somebody up on top made the illegal block. Very unusual when you see that on a dead ball situation. And I'm going to tell you, Kansas State now has 2 critical penalties against them. 1st and 10 after a great return, and they make it 1st and 15. Now they are penalized back to the 10, for a first down and 10. This is tough field position now for Roberson, who was having difficulty with that unusual Colorado defense. He'll just keep the ball and run, and he's not going to go very far. Now, let's conclude our lineup here, the Alamo. Now, Thomas Barnett, an outstanding left tackle, and that time, Roberson tried to get over behind him. Now, as far as Colorado is concerned, Tyler Brayton is stepping up, but they want more leadership in that defensive front. Gary, as a former quarterback, what's so unusual when you look at the Colorado D here today?
Colorado's defense has gone to the 4-4 front, similar to what Virginia Tech. You're going to see 100% man outside and almost 8 in the box and 9 in the box the whole game.
All right, we got the slot now off to the right. Roberson's looking for a receiver. Got a man diving incomplete down low.
Oh, that could have been caught.
I think it was incomplete all the way, though, wasn't it?
Yes, but it popped up, and I thought Billingsley almost got that ball.
I thought it had come up off the ground, but
he was wide open. The receiver's wide open, and Roberson threw it right in the ground on that open slant. James Terry's wide open on the play. Ball comes in and pops up, and it looks like Buck Brown. Brown was right there. Watch it pop. Hands are under it. Pops up and does it. Yeah, I think it hit the ground. Nose hit the ground.
Yeah, third down now. Roberson in a pass situation, and the Kansas State sideline has to be a little bit uneasy about this start here in Boulder today. Roberson gets a great block, and it's all diving reception by number 8. They're waving it off. The linesman's got it spotted at the 26-yard line. First down. On the deflection, Taco Wallace.
The tip didn't go the first time off the bounce, so they came right back to the tip pass. Phil Jackson, number 6, reads this play beautifully. Out and up, you're going to see it. He comes back. Taco Wallace says, hey, here's a free chalupa right here. I'll take it.
Burks, number 75, the right tackle, threw a big-time block as the defensive end had beaten him a little bit to the inside, and Burks was able to push him back out of the way. And there's a 12-yard thank you very much for Kansas State. Now they'll see if they can build off it. Ball out at the 26-yard line. Shotgun look now. Play fake inside. Here comes Roberson, a fine runner. Gets a block by the tight end. And he picks up about 14 yards out to the 40-yard line. So Oregon State, can they come back today? Let's find out from John Saunders. John.
Brent, already up a touchdown. Special teams take over. UCLA sit for a field goal. It is blocked by Nick Barnett. It drops right into the hands of Dennis Weathersby, and he sees daylight all the way to the end zone for the touchdown. Oregon State with a 14-0 lead in the first quarter. Brent.
Of course, Colorado beat up on UCLA after losing big time to USC. USC shut out Oregon State. Dennis Eriks is not used to that. Short gain as they go right ahead. And let's remind you about next Saturday, because it's certainly a day that if you're not at a game, you want to be in front of your TV. We'll start it at 12 Eastern. Florida State and number 1 Miami will start it off. Then most of you, certainly all of you in Big 12 country, will see the Red River Shootout, Texas and Oklahoma. Texas closing in today on a victory over Oklahoma State, and Oklahoma tonight will play Missouri. And I remember noon next week. That's the Miami-Florida State game, and that game is down Miami way. Second down now and 9 yards for Roberson. Roberson commits to that running game. Right straight ahead with Sproles. Number 54, Sean Tufts, playing with a broken hand, helped out defensively that time.
Let's take a look at what Kansas State is going to try to do. They got two quarterbacks, and they do not run the same offense with each quarterback. When L's in there, you're going to see a little option, then the power, play action, and more finesse. When Dunn comes in the football game, they still want to run that power game, but look, all of a sudden the pocket pass game starts to come in and finesses the screens and the draws and the quick screens that he likes to run off of it. Two different looks.
Travis Wilson's the fullback. Sproles the tailback. Third and 5. Here's that option. Roberson, late pitch. There's a penalty flag. Sproles in space for the first down, but there is a penalty flag thrown on the play. It was thrown back by the line of scrimmage, and Roberson is up there, and it's a holding call that'll bring back that game.
The 4th penalty of the game for Kansas State. Again, they had 12 of them and 5 turnovers against USC.
Offense, 10-yard penalty for the previous spot, deep burn down.
Now Snyder's got to come up with a passing play here.
And that's out of their comfort zone. Even the last one that they picked up was knocked down by Phil Jackson, could have been intercepted. So this is not the comfort zone for L. Roberson.
Joy Johnson in for the Buffaloes. He relays the signal. He's now one of the inside linebackers. From the eye, Roberson has time. Comes down the middle. Wallace in a foot race can't get there. Falls incomplete at the 15-yard line. Wallace had his man, Donald Strickland, beaten by a step. That would have been six had it been just a little bit shorter.
Pretty good play call that time by Bill Snyder. If you're going to throw and make the mistake way deep down the field instead of getting the ball picked off inside your own 50-yard line.
Here's a great story back to return this punt. And this is Jeremy Bloom. He's the mogul ski world champion. Gave up a lot of endorsement money to do just this. Looking for a seam right up the middle. Thrown down at the 26-yard line. So Colorado, with an early touchdown, leads Kansas State 7-0. Got a timeout.
To Nissan, it's a fusion of performance, styling, and innovation. To 50 renowned automotive journalists, however, it's an aphrodisiac. Presenting the Nissan Altima, 2002 North American Car of the Year.
My wife bought the same one. Didn't fit. I love it, but the kids are allergic.
Rashy.
How can I help you?
I'd like to return this.
No problem.
Okay, the thing is...
Sir, we'll take it back.
So I don't need it?
Nope.
Make returns, not excuses. Because at Circuit City, we offer easy, no-hassle returns and exchanges. Circuit City, we're with you.
We're moving to Europe, different plugs. You don't need it, but that's good.
My job is to predict the future. Every year, over 500,000 construction workers are injured in the U.S. So at Liberty Mutual, we're using 90 years of research and experience to help customers predict hazards and correct them. So accidents never happen in the first place. Some people say I'm psychic.
Liberty Mutual, it's more than insurance. It's insurance in action.
I say, hey, that's my job.
ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Nissan and your Nissan dealer. FedEx, Ground, International, Online, or Express, don't worry, there's a FedEx for that. Capital One, who asks, what's in your wallet? And Valvoline's MaxLife, the first motor oil formulated for higher mileage engines. Ah, the gorgeous Flatiron Mountains as you look down on Boulder, Colorado. 96,000 live in this beautiful mountain town, the University of Colorado. And the Buffaloes, having scored on their first series, come back out here with the Robert Hodge in that I formation. Drawn right in front of the big running back. Brian Calhoun, and he's a fine receiver. Calhoun's only a freshman. He sprints out, and Hodge on first down is going to put it up, and he's going to try to go deep. Got a man in a foot race. Here's Calhoun. The freshman will score. Touchdown. Not even Newman can catch him. 71 yards.
This one to Sean Watson and head coach Gary Barnett. They schemed that play. They worked on the new safety and they caught Bobby Walker coming too close to the line of scrimmage. That was a scheme play all the way.
What was interesting was watching the speed of Calhoun and then the blur.
Yeah, he came
in there,
didn't he?
Terrence Newman coming into the screen, man. It was unbelievable. So here's Brome now. Colorado is shocking favored Kansas State. We have a flag on the extra point thrown down in the end zone. So Robert Hodge, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen, has thrown his first touchdown pass ever. And it's 71 yards now. How many Colorado quarterbacks have come close to a 71-yard touchdown pass with their first TD pass? My man, the Platy man, the SID here at Colorado, he will have six pages of that stat.
After the play ended, there were personal fouls on both teams.
Not a bad start for Hodge. 4 for 4 in his fourth pass of the game is his first touchdown pass of his career. But this one was a scheme deal. Sean Watson, and they told us that they were going to try to isolate the running back. Watch him come into the picture right here on the safety, and that's exactly what they got. Walker sniffs inside, and then Calhoun goes right by him. Another perfectly thrown pass. Bobby Walker pulls up, and watch number 4 come into the picture. Just a too late.
2-touchdown lead. Timeout in Boulder.
Is briquette French for little brick?
Yeah.
Anyway, listen up. A barbecue grill manufacturer introduces a new model so big it puts all other ones to shame.
Even the really shiny ones?
Yeah, even the really shiny ones. Keep up.
They rely on FedEx Ground to get affordable nationwide B2B delivery with a money-back guarantee.
And backyard gourmets get the thriller of the griller. Must be a real knockout.
It's the greatest.
The undisputed heavyweight broiler of the world.
All right, that's enough.
No one spoils me like Mom, but Olive Garden comes close with their never-ending pasta bowl. They make all these delicious homemade sauces, then you pick which ones you want with which pastas. You get all you want, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks for $7.95. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Now there's a better way to soothe your skin after shaving. Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm has advanced moisturizers and vitamins to soothe and improve your skin. Nivea for Men. More Evolve skincare.
Ask a child where they'd like to go on vacation, and most likely it's the same place you'd like to go. A place where families can make memories together. A place where magic happens every day. And no one can take you there like Alamo, the official rental car of Walt Disney World Resort. Get a free child's breakfast with a favorite Disney character when you rent an Alamo car for as little as $130 per week. Alamo. The official rental car of the American vacation.
Tuesday, Jim meets his ultimate fantasy, Cindy Crawford.
Hey, maybe I'm Cindy Crawford's ultimate fantasy.
A new According to Jim Tuesday on ABC.
That fellow with the headset on is Bobby Pesavento. He has come back to pick up the 8 hours that he needs for his degree. Last year's quarterback, he led the Buffaloes to the Big 12 championship, the beating of Nebraska and the upset of Texas down in Dallas. Now, there's that short pooch kickoff we were expecting. This keeps Newman out. They put it in the hands of one of the linebackers, and then they swarm him at the 30-yard line. Let's go back to the touchdown,
Gary. Yeah, the creation here is perfect. Here's the tailback. He's going to come up and go on, and what happens is the free safety out of the picture just slightly is going to have to man-to-man cover him. Little motion, goes out. Kansas State's man-to-man, and all of a sudden, the free safety says, uh-oh, you mean I've got this running back all the way down the field? And it might, Terrence Newman might have caught him in 200 meters, but it was only a 65-yard field for him once he got it.
And I think you could see, number one, Bobby Walker pull up lame on the play. He reached for his left hamstring. Now, K-State in a catch-up mode. They need to battle back behind Roberson. Here comes the option. The quarterback is hit by Strickland back at the 27-yard line. Loss on the play. Let's remind everybody that Sydney Bristow always knew the job could kill her, but she didn't know her deadliest enemy was her mother. Let the adventure begin. A new Alias tomorrow at 9, 8 Central, right here on ABC.
One of the interesting things about this 4-4 look or 4-2-5 look, whatever, however you want to call it, the Virginia Tech defense is, it's very difficult to get wide on this defense. They have two safeties that just smell every play right here and right here. It forces you to run inside instead of outside.
Terry and Taco Wallace are the two wideouts. Roberson's got time, deflected on the ball as it was hit by Joey Johnson, the senior from San Antonio, Texas, number 43. Let's go down below to Jackaroo.
Brent, sometimes paranoia can run rampant, especially if you're a defensive coordinator like Vince Okrug. Now he's checking off his defensive plays. He's got two wristbands. Now there's a signal, and then he'll try and throw a dummy signal. He's using what he calls two bands to try and confuse K-State. He says, we think K-State picked up our signals the last time we played.
Third down and 13, but Colorado still won that game last year in Manhattan. They did lose to him here. In trouble. Penalty flag. Dropped off Bills, who's tackled at the 34-yard line, but the referee threw a penalty flag, and it's holding against Kansas State. The speed of that Colorado defense, and L. Roberson was asked by Jack Arute, just how fast are they? Here's his answer.
There are a bunch of guys that run to the ball, and that's something that we faced against USC, and we did a good job against, but I think they're much faster teams than USC.
Well, that would be a heck of a defense if they're faster than USC, but they have shown great speed here today. Travis Brown back now to punt, and here is Bloom waiting for another return for the Buffaloes, who have scored with their first two possessions. Fine high punt. The Gunners are having trouble get there. Great work. And Bloom, but there's a penalty flag. Bloom in a foot race. The punter to beat. Inside the 25, but I believe there's an illegal block. Thrown back at the 28-yard line. Penalty flag.
But Bloom is a prototype punt returner, isn't he? He makes that first move just like he's going down the moguls.
Jack, just how good is Jeremy Bloom on returning punts?
Well, Brett, Jeremy Bloom, an Olympic skier, didn't finish with a medal at the Salt Lake City Olympics, but the footwork, amazingly similar to the footwork you need to run back a punt. Now, Jeremy had to give up all of his endorsements and pay for his skiing to satisfy the NCAA requirements. He says he wants to go back and ski in the Olympics the next time around, but right now he wants to carry the football for the Buffaloes.
That was a revealing piece of tape, wasn't it, Gary?
Yeah, it really did look similar to me. You got to have those quick feet or knees, whatever, in mogul skiing, and he really just dodges those guys like they're moguls right in front of him. Very great quickness, great stop. Kansas State needs a three and out very bad.
What a start for Hodge. 4 of 4 for 125 yards and
good,
a touchdown.
Good coaching, though, Brent. They have not given him a difficult throw yet.
So Chris Brown back in as the running back. The freshman's job is done for the time being. There's the draw play. And Brown brings it up to about the 23-yard line. Well, speaking of winter sports, Olympic gold medalist Sarah Hughes, Michelle Kwan, Sasha Cohen, Timothy Gabel, America's Best, compete at the Campbell's International Figure Skating Classic tomorrow, 2 Eastern, 3 Pacific, right here on ABC.
Look at that. Again, first down for Colorado. They just destroy people on first down. Second and one. You didn't find any quarterback make this work.
And Colorado spreads the field. They've got great confidence in what Hodge is doing now. Middle deflected. Good work by the heart of that defensive line as Andrew Schull, a junior from Webb City, Missouri, able to knock that one down, move into the middle. Now here's our quarterback comparison, and it is pretty one-sided.
Really is. Give a little credit here to the speed of that Colorado defense that we saw, but Hodge looks so much more. When you go into the Rose Bowl and beat UCLA, I think you have a lot of comfort of what you might be able to do back at home.
Third down and one. So Texas has a scare. They survive 17-15. They'll go unbeaten to take on Oklahoma and Dallas. And here the Kansas State defense trying to stop Chris Brown, but you can see he muscles his way for the first down. The big fella transferred here from Northwestern. Why did he transfer, Gary?
I think it was just he was comfortable with Gary Barnett. I know they tried the new coaching staff was thinking they might want to look at him at tight end, but sometimes when you get recruited by a guy, that's the guy you feel most comfortable with. I think it happens a lot in college football.
K-State has been unable to stop the Colorado offense. That's our big storyline of this game. One of the reasons why has the ball in his hands right now, and he is stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. James McGill, the safety.
Well, even though we thought Colorado was going to come out here and try to play a power football game, I think what Barnett and Sean Watson have realized is they did not want the momentum of this game to go towards Kansas State. They want to keep them off balance and not put Robert Hodge in a position where he has to make a throw. So by throwing a little bit more, he's giving them a little easier time out there.
Colorado is really keeping number 4 Newman out of the play. They're just running him away from the play. on every down. A receiver took him deep on that running play. Hickman, fine linebacker, comes up and makes the stop of Brown that time, and Hodge and the Buffaloes will face a tricky third down.
Well, we all know when Colorado made their run last year, they did it with power football. That's still what they make their living on. A little more play action passes with Robert Hodge, and then the finesse plays. That's the little bootlegs, the sprint outs that we'll see more of the Mike Machete offense than we saw the Craig Oaks offense, that now that Robert Hodge has gotten comfortable being the starter.
Another good receiver is in a running back right now, number 42, Bobby Purify. He's replaced Brown. This is a throwing down. They motion him out of the backfield. They slot Purify. Hodge pulls back, looks to set the screen, and he does to the fullback. No first down because of a fine tackle. Hit Reese was over there, and so was Hickman.
One of the plays that Colorado has not shown this year is a screen pass to Brandon Dunn. They had said they were going to feature it on third down, and Kansas State maybe got the most important stop of the game for them. They needed a three and out. They got one first down, but they got the ball back.
Here's Mariscal now. He's a fine punter, and Newman will try to get his hands on the ball again. Now they were going to punt it away from him. They'll put Sproles back there. Barnett's plan was to punt the ball out of bounds, not even let him touch it. Let's see what happens here now with Mariscal. Newman says let it roll. Sproles picks it up instead at the 26, looks for the sideline, and they'll swarm him at the 34-yard line. Now, the frustration of number four, Terrence Newman, a big focal point of the game plan. That ball is not even close to him. Down goes the wide receiver, and the Buffaloes just try to run him right out of every play. That was the plan all week long here in Boulder.
Stay away from that matchup. There's 10 other matchups out there that they can exploit. Why go after their best one, right?
Exactly. Roberson's still your quarterback for Kansas State. He's down a couple of scores. Ball just shy of the 35-yard line. Roberson runs behind the fullback, breaks to daylight, dives across midfield with a first down. That's a fine 15, 16-yard run that time for the quarterback. And it gives K-State very good field position. One of the things about Kansas State under Snyder, and Gary and I have been there before, even when they fall behind, they're a very dangerous football team. They have a way of battling their way back into the contest. I remember last year down at Oklahoma, they were in trouble early.
He keeps probing. Does a lot of different things in this offense. I think he's adjusted well, though. He's trying to spread out this 4-4 defense with a lot of receivers.
Giving himself a fullback with the quarterback. Now Roberson comes up under center. Five left on the clock. He's got to go again. Down to three now. Gets it off. Looks option. Breaks a tackle, but not the second one. That was Walruse bringing him down. And let's check in with Jack.
Maybe one of the reasons why the Wildcats are able to come back the way they do is what coaches of Kansas State say about their quarterback, L. Roberson. They say that he operates the best when he's got a chip on his shoulder. They say that he tends to focus more when he's down for the count. Well, I don't know about you, but 14 points the differential right now. Maybe we're starting to see some of that focus from Roberson. Maybe the chip's growing.
Exactly, because he's only two plays away from tying it up. 14-0 always seems greater than it is. We've got to move on that clock again. Brings the option, and he was keeping it all the way. And now it'll be third down. Well, Roberson is a tough hombre, but you can almost tell that he likes to run, can't you, Gary?
What's given, Kansas State's a little bit of a problem is the free safety, the extra guy, whether it's number 17 Moore or number 5 J.J. Billingsley, the true freshman who made such a hit here with all the tackles. He is sneaking up to become the extra guy in the box, and that free safety standing right there, and they cannot account for the free safety.
Can he get it off before the end of the quarter? Cannot. The end of the first quarter. Well, one of the storylines, a young man who got away from Barry Alvarez. He's out of Oak Creek, Wisconsin. McCoy set up the first, and Brown ran it in. After that, it was Brian Calhoun. Touchdown, Colorado, 14-0.
This Heisman memory is presented by Suzuki Motorcycles.
In 1998, Ricky Williams of Texas became the second Longhorn to win the Heisman Trophy. On November 27, Williams set the record for the most career rushing yards, breaking Tony Dorsett's 22-year-old mark.
60 yards of the record is his, and a standing ovation for the king of the rushers.
From the minds that brought you the Hayabusa and GSXR sport bikes comes the all-new QuadSport Z400. Is it still showing off if no one's around to see you?
The heat is on when mozzarella, pepper jack, cheddar, and nacho cheese sauce form a taste to die for. Don't miss the new cheese extreme quesadilla.
Four cheeses.
Four. You gotta be insane.
Nature made it. Minwax makes it beautiful with rich wood stains and long-lasting protective finishes. Turning a house into a beautiful home is as easy as turning to Minwax.
Kansas State now playing catch-up football, but they seem to be, I think you pointed out, slowly getting into their groove.
I think so. I think Bill Snyder said, we're not going to be able to defeat this 4-4 defense just running with I formation. We have to spread them out a bit, force L. Roberson to run some options, try to spread this defense out and make some things happen.
Third down and short. They need 2 yards for the first down. Roberson himself will sneak for the first down inside the Colorado 40-yard line. So good field position now for Ron Hudson, who's the offensive coordinator upstairs for Bill Snyder. But Snyder very much involved with the play calling down below. They've taken a look at this offense, and I should say this defense.
Here's this safety right here that's giving them problems. Free safety's coming out there, man-to-man on the outside. The safety sneaking up. Look at that.
First down and 10. Picks it back up, and a little bit of hesitation. We allowed him to attack that seam. Isn't it interesting, Gary, when there's a little bit of a delay sometimes? Well, it's just like a draw play, really,
right,
in effect.
It really was. But you know what? Things out here for Colorado, they won the championship last year, the Big 12 championship. But going down the stretch, they gave up points. Nebraska scored 36, Texas 37, and then Oregon 38 in the Fiesta Bowl. So Gary Barnett said, we have to change. We need to come up with a different defense. And the new deal is man-to-man. Cover a man and do not give up the box.
Three wide to the right for L. Roberson. But he will run it behind the fullback. And he is down at the 30-yard line. This will leave him with about a third and three. Let's check in now on the Longhorns. Let's go to John Saunders.
Well, Brent, you had to wonder, would they look ahead past Oklahoma State to next week's matchup against Oklahoma? Only a two-point lead. Josh Fields, though, is picked off by Rod Babers, and that interception seals the victory. Texas steals a two-point lead heading into next week. Brent.
So Sims puts it up 46 times today. It'll be interesting to see what kind of game plan Mack Brown has for the Sooners next week. Again, Oklahoma plays Missouri later today in the Big 12. Here's Roberson, and one man, bang, breaks free. Cuts away from Jackson. And brought down from behind at the 2-yard line. Walrus caught him. But the Wildcats are in business with a 28-yard run for Roberson, who has 81 yards.
Give this one to Ron Hudson. Kansas State came with their elephant backfield. They call it their big Nick backfield. Vic, Nick, and Thick. Only this time they faked to the big guy, and Roberson kept it. That was a good game plan. Roberson gets into the secondary, beats Billingsley, the free safety, and you see what Roberson gives him, an extra running back in the backfield.
Since he's rushed for 82 yards already, he might as well keep it right in his hand and let him go right straight ahead. They've given him Victor Mann in this moose backfield look. Three fullbacks, and they'll hand it off, and nothing doing. And Mann is the redshirt freshman from Fort Worth, Texas. He could not get into the end zone. I don't know why he just don't say, go get it for me, number three.
Well, that and Iosaba, number 36, is the guy, is the big one by tailback also. But I don't know. I think keeping Sproles in the game is not a bad idea.
Well,
then you have the threat of the option. Yeah, then you have the threat of the option when you have Sproles in the football game. Here he is, back in.
Sproles, end zone, touchdown, K-State. Two plays away, and there's the first one.
Well, the defense got a stop, and all of a sudden, Roberson's running really has kept Colorado's defense off balance just enough. And the left side of their line is their best side of the line. Barnett and Leckie is over there, 65 and 53, and they run right by him. This is the swinging gate that Kansas State uses a lot in their field goal. A shift. They have gone for two out of that swinging gate look.
Jared Bright tacks on the extra point. Here's the touchdown. Behind the fullback, the power eye with the pulling lineman helping lead the way. Touchdown, K-State.
For me,
the price
is nice.
He'll wear
this pair.
Wow, they're just $15 to $20 for men and boys.
Old Navy, we are there.
You don't need to be a sanitation engineer to know garbage when you see it. Looks like you'll be folding faster than the Argentine army in 82. Oh, well, buck up, soldier. The night is young. Lucky for you, there's also a lightweight to live, the high life.
She never imagined her deadliest enemy would be her mother.
You are a traitor.
Like mother, like daughter, like hell. A new alias, ABC Sunday.
Calhoun. There's our Pontiac performance drive summary. The final yard in that drive, of course, was the touchdown scored by Sproles. And so now Kansas State trailing at 14-7. Right with the ball on the tee. Calhoun and Snead are back. And this one will go completely out of the end zone. Well, a reminder that Monday night, from Champaign, Illinois. It'll be the Bears and the Packers, one of the great rivalries, and I'll be disappointed if the Monday Night Crew doesn't show us Rhett Grange right off the top in black and white out of Champaign. One of those guys that made the National Football League what it is today. Then you can settle in and watch Brett Favre duel away, and you can see he is four touchdown passes shy of 300. He will join some very elite company. Reno, Tarkenton, and John Elway. John just down the road here in Denver, of course. He's bought himself a Arena Football League team. He's done very well with his car dealerships that he sold in this area. Play fake now by Hodge. Gets time, deflected, incomplete, and that was a nice defensive play by Rashad Washington, the junior from Wichita, number two, making a good play, Gary.
Former running back has moved over to strong safety this year, and that time he had man-to-man coverage on the tight end. You can see it starting to evolve right here. Bobby Elliott, defensive coordinator for the Kansas State, is saying, all right, let's just find our guy, stay with him, keep our linebackers in the box. We must stop the run first, and then let our secondary guys take care of the pass.
Colorado was stopped on its last series. Option look, Hodge, penalty flags come flying.
Before the snap occurred, false start on the offense. 5 yards, second down.
Now it is Colorado starting to make mistakes. And it is time for our Aflac trivia question this week. What Kansas State alum is a star of the senior PGA Tour and has a golf course named after him in Manhattan, Kansas? We always talk about Hale Irwin, the great golfer who played football here in Colorado, but now which K-State alum? You people in Manhattan, you're not eligible to answer that one. That one's too easy. That was a gift. That's a home run. Second down and 15. Shotgun look. There's that delay with Brown bashing his way. Number seven, Josh Buell, fine linebacker right there, makes the stop. Well, there's your Big 12 today. Texas and a Donnybrook. Nebraska beats up on McNeese State. Texas A&M ahead big. And Baylor trying to end a 29-game losing streak in the conference. And later today, it's Oklahoma and Missouri.
I think it's going to be a tough game for Oklahoma. I think Missouri will be ready for them to play. Oklahoma is going to have to prove they can run the ball tonight.
Need 14 yards, the Buffaloes. They're backed up third and 14. There's a lot of folks here wearing purple from Kansas State. There is the toss now to Purify. Tries to run it wide, shy of the 20. Tank Reese, number 30, says no further.
That was a good call, I think, by Colorado. They did not want to force a mistake down in their own territory. Robert Hodge, if you're going to let him throw when you got the lead, do it on your terms, not on the defensive terms. I think that's a good situation to just punt the ball and say, defense, stop their quarterback this time.
Now Newman would dearly love to give him field position. Mariscal will hit this from inside his 10.
Looks like he's angled to the sideline as he stands, though, doesn't it? Mariscal.
They told us they were going to punt it out of bounds. They do not. He drills it to the wind. Here he comes. He bobbles it, picks it up at the 20, beats the first man, looks for the seam into the arms of the Buffaloes, and down he goes to the 28. Walruse, number 16, is all over the field. He made the stop on the speedster. Timeout.
Hey, hand me that there,
Wrench?
Yeah.
Oh!
What, do you think I got that insurance or something?
What?
It puts money in your wallet in case you're, like, flat on your back.
What? Never heard of it.
Well, you can get it at work.
Get what?
Aflac. Ask about it at work. There's a place where I get my favorite Italian sauces, with all kinds of pastas, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks. Sounds like mom's house, but it's Olive Garden and their never-ending pasta bowl for $7.95. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
The best part is that look on their faces when they see how many miles I have on it.
Take pride in your odometer with Valvoline's Max Life. It helps keep higher mileage engines running for a long, long time.
Yo, me, where's the dick?
Only Tostitos scoops have the bite-sized bowl-shaped design that's perfect for dipping and dunking every time.
I thought that was a myth.
So however you like to dip, there's only one dip lover's chip.
I own this court. Yeah. No, I really own this court. You guys gotta go.
Tostitos Scoops, the dip lover's chip.
ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Pontiac, fuel for the soul. The people of Allstate, you're in good hands with Allstate. And the delicious flame broiled Whopper from Burger King at BK, you got it. Ah, that snow-capped Rocky Mountain Front Range. There's snow up there. Some of the skiers will be coming out here soon. A lot of them like to spend the Thanksgiving holiday. Hope for a good snowpack this year. They need moisture up and down the Rocky Mountain area. 14-7 now. Roberson and Kansas State down, with Roberson again changing it up at the line of scrimmage. Sproles is his tailback in that deep spot back there. And Roberson going to pull it out. And he's going to look downfield. He's going to go deep. Walks on the juggle. Got it. Incomplete. They wave it off. It looked for a moment like Taco had himself a big gain. But he just let it slip away.
Roberson made a nice throw here, Brent. He had pressure right in his face as he left us. This is right off the option. But Taco Wallace had this ball, jumped when he really didn't need to, and then never really had control. And as he hit the ground, he's bobbling it. They called it incomplete. Roberson throw it, and just as he lets it go, you see how he almost go backwards as he let the ball go, because Marcus Harris is right in his face.
I'll tell you, Strickland got up on Wallace and helped jar that ball loose, too. Second down and 10. Here comes Roberson, still got it in a dash. Open field. Tried to get a block from a receiver. Got it. Sideline. They won't get him. Touchdown. The Wildcats. They come back with their own 71-yard touchdown. It's the magic number of the day as Roberson does it. And credit number 82, James Terry, the wide receiver, with clearing the way. He got the final block on the corner.
Watch how they run the option here without a pitch man, but they do. Sproles is going to come on the right side of your screen as the pitch man. You see him right here. That's what allowed Roberson to run the play up the middle. They used the slot option, and then James Terry gets the push down deep. Phil Jackson falls down, and Roberson's doing it almost by himself.
Bright for the tie. Got it. Indeed, by himself. Roberson, 12 carries, 153 yards, and one touchdown.
Another beautifully designed play. We called it a chess match early. Both coaches have been designing plays to get big plays. Bill Snyder, Ron Hudson has countered against Sean Watson and Gary Barnett, both coaches coming out.
Well, Jack Arute went to Manhattan, the little Manhattan, if you will, and he asked Al about his thought process before a play. Here's what he had to say.
I want to get everybody up to the line of scrimmage, and I want to check my play clock and see how much time I have. And then I'll look to the defense, see where the safeties are, follow my linebackers, and just get a feeling of what they're doing around in the secondary.
Rel Roberson has not done it with his arm, but he has done it as a running quarterback today. Again, there's no tailback here on the option. So when you fake, Colorado says, who are you gonna pitch to? But the design of the play was to put your tailback out wide and have him back up to be the designated pitch man. A beautifully designed play.
Terry with that good downfield block. We told you when it was 14-0 that the one thing we'd experience with Snyder and Kansas State was a very patient, well-coached football team. They would take it a play at a time. They have now had a time to study this unorthodox defense. Not so unorthodox. You just don't see it in college football that much. And they certainly now have come up with some solutions. There's that high Calhoun, the freshman, makes a mistake. Out of bounds. At the 7-yard line, tough field position. Well, earlier we asked you the Aflac trivia question. Kansas State golfer on the senior tour, all together now from Manhattan. Let me hear you. Jimmy Culver, here he is. His grandson right now attends Kansas State. We hope Jimmy's watching. He's a great football fan, been a loyal alum, and I understand that Jimmy's golf course there is a dandy. And if you play it in the breeze, folks, bring your A game. First down and 10 now for the Buffaloes. They are up 14-0. Now they're in a dogfight. Browns that eye back. on the toss. Behind Drum, cuts inside. Well, it is certainly worth another look, Gary, and you can't say enough about the block he gets.
Here's Sproles right here. The big block is going to happen down here in man-to-man coverage, but usually you don't run an option when you don't have anybody to pitch to, but you see how Sproles backs up as the pitch right there? This is reminiscent to me, Brent, of Bradley Van Pelt and what Colorado State did to Colorado. Remember, Van Pelt that day had a big game against this team, and it looked like that game tape got a lot of viewing over in Manhattan.
You bet. Van Pelt had a long touchdown run against Fresno State last night, but Colorado State comes up 2 points shy on the two-point conversion. Here's Brown again, and back in the end zone to my left and behind the play. Folks, you would think we're in Manhattan, Kansas. I mean, look at that back there. I mean, yep. It's not, you know, there's a few Colorado. It's, what's going on here?
And every one of those, Brent, on the way here asked you to not to be fair with Kansas State today, did they?
I understand why. Yes.
Just about every one of them, I recognize all those guys. Come on, Brent. Come on, Brent.
Altica, say something nice. We want some love. Okay.
Hey, when your quarterback goes for 12 for 153, you get some love.
Exactly. Third down and 7. Moved along with him, but he got his foot set again. Hit on the release. If that's a fumble, it's a free ball. No incomplete pass. The linesman is waving it off. He is saying incomplete pass. The linesman had the view. It was close, folks, real close.
And the game referee was right behind there. John Bible was right behind the play, too, signaling incomplete pass. But, boy, Hodge sets back. This is not his comfort zone. And coming as he gets ready to throw, Melvin Williams, and yes, it looked like his arm had started that. It's a correct call. Kansas State has taken control of this game.
Now the punter backed up inside his end zone. Mariscal. He hit one 61 yards last time. He needs another 60-yarder here. Drills it. About 54 yards. Measured from the goal line. So he hit it longer than that. Sproles, the return man. There's a penalty flag down. But K-State will be working with half a field right now. 8 minutes to go here. We'll get the call and we'll take a quick break and come back to watch the K-State offense.
Or Roberson. One of the same thing, right?
Illegal block in the back on the return team. 10 yards from where the run ended. First down.
5 penalties against Kansas State for 45 yards. 2 for 15 against Colorado. Take a timeout. Big 12 football. It's a dandy.
For men, every morning it's the same routine. The desperate search for a way to relieve the pain after shaving. There's a better way to soothe your skin. Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm is an advanced blend of moisturizers and vitamins that soothe and actually improve your skin. Nivea for Men, more evolved skincare.
What is wrong with you?
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. Bright copper kettles and warm wooden mittens. White whiskers that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. These are a few of my favorite things.
Get up! Get on up!
Get on up!
Get up!
Get on up!
Get on up! Come on up! Stay on the scene like a sex machine.
Try talking to your dad during football.
Would it kill you to take the time to listen to me?
I always have time to listen to you, just not right now.
8 simple rules. Join the fun. ABC Tuesday.
Gary Danielson and Jack Arruda. I'm Brett Musburger. So, Gary, what's your overview right here?
A nice adjustment by Kansas State. They've spread out their formations. They're not going to try to attack these 9-man fronts. Great adjustment.
And Newman's in on offense. He's out to the right side of the formation right here. There he is, number 4. They're going to motion him and see what Colorado's going to do. They're going to give it to him on a handoff. All kinds of penalty flags come flying.
I think it was an illegal formation. They either had 12 men or they didn't have enough men on the line of scrimmage.
So Terrence Newman, he wants the ball. And we ask him about that, and here's what he had to say.
The thrill of being out there and being chased, you know, it's different for me because I'm usually doing the chasing, and now I'm the one trying to elude all the tacklers.
Folks, he is not a track man dabbling in football. He's a football player who happens to be very, very fast. Someone here by the name of Eric Bieniemy said he'd seen a couple of fellas in the NFL who could move like that. One happens to be Deion Sanders, and he was the fastest defensive back I ever saw during his college days. But if this fella can run like that and play football like Deion, he's got a long, long career ahead of him. As a matter of fact, my friend's down with the Kansas City Chiefs. There's a guy. Here's your shutdown corner. Get number four. Tied at 14 now with 8 minutes to go. Newman was in, and now he's back on the sideline. Danny Morris and Darren Sproles. There's that delay with Sproles. Cuts to the hole.
He's up, guys. He's up here.
Walrus and Moore make the stop. So here on a beautiful day in Boulder, Colorado, we're tied at 14, Gary.
Well, it started off with Robert Hodge making some big plays with his arm, but with Calhoun. But then L. Roberson has taken it with his legs. You would think it'd be the other way around. You think Hodge would do it with his legs, but Roberson has come and shot this team with a little bit of option, a little bit of quarterback keeper from shotgun, and really changed the complexion of the game.
Second and 12. Option look. Pitch. Sproles is going to throw it. Wants Taco Wallace. Strickland slips, but the ball was not that well thrown. Strickland slipped trying to keep up with Wallace, and he's having a little difficulty handling him over there, although it's going to be a great battle today.
A little bit of a surprising call there to me. Second and long, Colorado really was thinking pass. You see Strickland, he's man-to-man all the way. The ball is now thrown, but as he turns for it, he might have been able to get to it, but it was well overthrown. Good job of reading the play and doing your assignment.
Roberson needs 12. Three wides for Kansas State, and Sproles a running back. Roberson goes straight back, hit on the release, incomplete. And K-State is forced to punt, and Roberson takes a hit that time. In on top of him was Tyler Brayton.
That was the wide receiver screen that time. The offensive line was allowing that Colorado rush to come inside, but Roberson could not find Taco Wallace again. They've been trying to go to Taco, but they have not been able to get to him.
Travis Brown punting and Jeremy Bloom, the skier, back deep. Standing inside the Colorado 15-yard line. 7-12 left here in the first half. Looking for a Bloom return. There's a penalty flag. Bloom to daylight. Oh, he is slammed at the 30-yard line. We do have a penalty flag back on the 40-yard line.
Pretty sure Colorado was holding right after the punt that time. One of the inside men. Now they're deciding whether it was before the ball was punted, and I think it was after. It was very close because it happened inside the line of scrimmage.
This is such a pivotal game for both of these teams in the Big 12 North here today, both wanting to jumpstart their season with Nebraska in a bit of a decline. The winner here could well be
holding
the favorite
the
along with Iowa State.
It'll be 10 yards from the previous spot. It'll remain fourth down.
He looked over there to see if it was going to give him a first down, but it did not because it was fourth down and 12. Now Bloom goes back deep, and it's interesting that Newman's going to try to come down the field on this punt. Now I think they're going to bring him off. He was out there for a moment, and now he comes off.
Well, Terry Pierce made the big hit last
time. They'll take Bloom out on the other side. So Pierce got downfield on Bloom. They'll take him out there, run McCoy in now. Fresh set of hands back there on the 10-yard line.
Now if you're Colorado, you probably have to stay defense stays and
you
make sure.
You've got to watch the fake here in this situation. Yep, back looks like the big bruising linebacker. They go ahead with a great punt. The wind's got this one. Great punt. Knocked out of bounds at the 7-yard line. So again, Hodge and the Buffaloes will be backed up in the shadow of their own goal. We're tied at 14 and over. Timeout.
Closely, and you can see a CEO, a senator, a teacher with the largest leadership studies program in the Big 12. It's easy to see why Kansas State University is ranked by high school counselors as one of the top 10 undergraduate experiences in the nation. Start your future as a leader. Kansas State University.
Colorado scored on their first two series in this game, but since then, as you can see, Hodge has been slowed down, only 1 of 3 for a pair of yards. Bad field position. Bobby Purify tries to give him a little dash. He'll take that handoff, try to spread the defense out. Breaks a tackle, and he's out of bounds. James McGill couldn't bring him down. And a reminder, next Saturday now, that doubleheader. It kicks off at noon with Florida State Miami coming from Miami. The unbeaten Canes and Ken Dorsey try to keep rolling. Against the Seminoles, have lost once. Then most of you will see Chris Sims in Texas take on OU in the Red River Shootout from Big D. We'll start at noon next Saturday here on ABC. Right now in Boulder, Colorado, second down and 8 for the Buffaloes. 3 wide. And they run off the formation, get a hole. But Purify brought down by Buell, who's a fine linebacker at the 15. Jackaroo.
But when Robert Hodge took over for the departed Craig Oakes, the offensive coordinator Sean Watson figured he'd better turn the page back to 1999. You remember that's when Mike Muschietti was here at Colorado. Now both Muschietti and Hodge are about the same height, so Sean said he went back, reviewed the tapes to get ideas that plays that would better suit Hodge considering his height. But he does say Hodge is different than Muschietti. He says he's more conservative. He says Mike, he'd throw the ball, not always to the right guy.
All right, Drum, this is a big third down play now as far as field position is concerned in this game. Buffaloes have got it. Open field in a foot race. Chris Brown back on the field. Newman trying to get the angle. Can't get him. Touchdown. Brandon Drum blows it open, and it's 85 yards for Chris Brown. What a block by the Alaskan Assassin.
Kansas State coaches are going to be very upset with James McGill. Safety missed that first tackle on going outside and then missed on that short yardage play. You can give him a first down, but you can't give him 85 and a touchdown.
From behind Brown. And what impressed scouts? Two things. Drum blows it open. And Newman, with the angle, cannot catch Brown.
Well, let's watch Drum. Drum is right here. He comes up in motion and stands right there. And then the ball is snapped, and the offensive line does a good job of opening up that hole. Nice hole. Now you're going to give him a first down right here, but watch from the corner right here. Your safety must not whiff like that. James McGill came in, remember, he's subbing for Bobby Walker, and instead of giving him a first down with 5 minutes, 6 minutes to go, you give him a touchdown. Remember the play before? McGill came up and kind of ducked his head. Maybe that's why McGill was backup instead of a starter.
So Brown, showing you his great talents, has to be one of the leading candidates right now for the Doak Walker Award, which goes to the best running back in college football. In our Pacific Life game summary, in a wide open affair, Roberson's running, keeping K-State right in the thick of things. It was Hodges passing early, and then Brown with his career long 85 yards for the go ahead touchdown. He now has scored twice, and that's our Pacific Life game summary here from Boulder, Colorado.
It's been big plays for Colorado, the long pass and the long run. Kansas State prides themselves on making them go the long way. Remember, they only gave up 96 yards a game last year on the ground.
That's the favorite play of Chris Brown. That running play, dive for that open ball on that short pooch punt. I believe K-State able to get on the ball at the 40-yard line.
Danny Morris, number 34, made a brilliant play on this one. This ball would have bounced.
Well, here's what Brown said when you asked him about his favorite play. We just saw it, Gary.
Probably has to still be that 98 G lead from last year. Everybody made a big deal about. It's pretty much the car pulls around outside, Drum follows him, and I follow Drum, and Drum just leads me on through.
There it was, touchdown Colorado.
I haven't seen him that open since Nebraska.
First down and 10. Here's Sproles now. He's got daylight. 45. And he's out of bounds inside the 40-yard line with 5:41 to go. The shootout continues here in the shadow of the Rockies.
I'd like to be a defensive coordinator in modern college football nowadays. So many different ways to attack you. The mobile quarterbacks have come in and changed the game. You have to keep on extra defensive backs. They may go five wide receivers, four wide receivers. And if you're Vince Okrug, you said, why can't I go back to those days in the Big Ten when it was I formation and runoff tackle?
First down and 10 for the Wildcats. You can see better than 2-1 run. And here they come again. Nothing doing this time as the Buffalo swarm Sproles. Needs a little help getting up a little gingerly that time. Tufson, Brayton make the stop. Jack.
Brenny's just 5'7 and just 170 pounds. That's why they call him the little man. But despite his size, they say that he's one of the most durable of the K-State running backs. Now, the CU coaches say that his size creates a situation where he can hide behind his blockers and defenders can't get an eye on him until he's in that sixth gear and hits the hole. That's why they nicknamed him Tank.
Meanwhile, there was a penalty against Colorado, so they will take the penalty, and it is first down and five. First and five now for K-State after the five-yarder against Colorado.
The formation they ran the option off of, here it is again. Now this time they hand off.
He's up, guys. He's up.
Victor Mann, the redshirt freshman, had checked in, I thought. They had a little bit of a different look that time, and they came back with the
same play, same series Mann. That they have. You sure will see that again.
Mann lines up as the fullback, and here comes Sproles over in the slot. Setting the clock to 25 seconds, the play clock. Now it starts down.
Colorado must be thinking option here. They'll back up Sproles, fake in here, and Roberson will keep around to the left.
Right straight ahead. Running man. Colorado jumps it, no first down. Masoni. He makes a stop, number 12.
Sony's one of those slash song safeties slash outside linebackers in this 4-2 look. Call it a 4-2, call it a 4-4, but those guys have to be involved in the run game and the pass game.
Travis Wilson, the K-State fullback, is in front of Sproles. Third down and two as Roberson changes it up at the line. Clock down inside of five. Option look, hit on the pitch. Sproles picks it up, beats the first man, and won't get the first down. Great defense that time. The first man, Sean Tufts, blew the play up.
Absolutely. Came in there. And Roberson had to pitch the ball before he wanted to. Watch number 54 show up right in his face. I have to pitch. He wasn't ready to pitch. Got it out there. Too much of a lead for Sproles. Great defensive situation. You knew that option was coming sooner or later for Kansas State.
3:25 to go now, and it is a fourth down. K-State's going to call a timeout. I don't know how long the field goal kicker's leg is. They've had a duel. They've got a wind at their back. They're going to talk about it. We'll take a timeout.
No flags behind it. It's touchdown.
She gives it to Nancy in the middle. She swings. She got it down. Regional champions.
And good execution by Oklahoma.
The Texas Longhorns are national champions.
And the winner is Eric Crouch.
The first man in the history of athletic competition to go undefeated, never a loss.
Well, we've had these three, not big, huge plays, ladies and gentlemen. 271-yarders, and a moment ago, the 85-yarder from Brown. We've had 268 yards of offense for Colorado and 206 for Kansas State. So we've had almost 500 yards of offense here in the first half, and they send the punter Travis Brown, the senior from Overland Park, Kansas, back onto the field. He'll try to get this one down inside the 10. He did a brilliant job last time, but the defense let Brown out with the 85 yarder. Bloom will go back and stand at the 10 yard line. Pierce late arriving, and now they've got 12 men on the field, I believe, or no, they're just readjusting one of the gunners. They're both going to come down left, so he's going to aim it in that direction. This one, the wind's got it. But he got it inside the 10-yard line, out at the four. It'll be marked down there. The referee and the field judge line up with each other, and that's going to be marked right at the 5-yard line. And coming up on the Valvoline Halftime Show, John Saunders and Terry Bowden will have all the scores and highlights from around the country. So we look forward to John and Terry. Now, remember, these two guys have both said, OU, OU, OU. So, well, the Texas had a scare today, and we'll see if they talk a little Longhorn here at halftime.
Well, two good teams. I can't wait to get there, but I can't wait to watch the rest of this game. Remember, Kansas State has all three timeouts remaining. They would love to force a punt here.
Chris Brown, who went 85, he's the I-back coming again. And this time, Kansas State jumps it. Corey White and Melvin Williams here in Boulder, Colorado. Big play day. L. Roberson keeps it, and he goes 71 yards for the touchdown. Then it was Colorado's turn, and Brown exploded 85. Folks, watch number four come from the left side. He couldn't get there. The handoff now. Brown is buried at the five. How much time do we have? 2:38. Corey White. Snyder wants one more crack at it before the intermission, Gary.
Everybody's looking at Coach Snyder or whether he wants to use a timeout. He's going to play it a little safe. There's plenty of time left. He'll wait until after third down before he'll use his timeout.
There's our offensive leaders here, Gary.
Well, you can see the big throw to Calhoun. It's been a quiet day in the passing game. They needed Brown to come through, and he did on that third and short. Again, a very dangerous situation for Colorado, putting Robert Hodge in the situation where he has to throw.
Purify checks in at running back. And Bloom, one of the wideouts. In fact, he's the only wide receiver. K-State of Manning. Play fake. Hodge going to look for him. Going to go to Bloom. Bloom breaks free. He's got it. Foot race. Here comes Jeremy Bloom. Headed for the and gentlemen. Oh, yeah, give him a medal. It's Big Play Saturday in Boulder, Colorado. 271s, an 85 and a 94.
It was third and long. Kansas State went man to man and Jeremy ran a stutter and go. Another call by Colorado to say if you're going to make a mistake, make it way down there.
Now Bloom tacks on the extra point. You know, you talk about Bloom and they recruited him to return punts. But in high school here in Colorado, he was an outstanding receiver. I believe it was up in Fort Collins.
Down here at the bottom, he's matched up against Randy Jordan. Watch him come up and stutter. Stutter right there. Jordan bites, and that's all it is. There's no safety on the field. It's pitch and catch. And then Jeremy at the end here thought he had the clocking right there and almost stopped a little too slow soon.
Now don't be throwing those poles up in the air.
That's
too
exactly
fast.
Right. Look at this. Watch his stutter. What a beautiful move. Comes out, bit on very badly by Randy Jordan that time. Jordan could never get back into it. And Bloom says, I'm going to go all the way on this one. I've never seen this many big plays in a football game. Third and long, and they say no free safety.
And Terrence Newman, you know, he could go over to Coach Barnett and say, come on, coach, throw me one pass on my side of the field. Everything's gone on the other side. They have stayed away from him. He's not even getting, he's got to come at a severe angle.
I'm surprised he wasn't over there covering that time because Colorado only had one wide receiver that time.
You know what I'd do, Gary? I'd move him back to safety and let him play center
field. Maybe. At least they wouldn't go all the way.
Absolutely. I'd get him off the corner. There's that pooch. Short grounded there. And that was Andy Clock, the linebacker. There's that short pooch punt. So let's see. We've got 143 now for Snyder's offense. Roberson will come back out here.
Let's take one more. Here's Newman right over here. Only one wide receiver, and the matchup is to here. Newman, again, keep him out of the game. These two guys come back and block. He's just standing there on this big play. Watch this. Newman says, I can't do anything with my speed standing over here.
See, that's great coaching.
Absolutely. That's what you do. You got a good
guy. I saw where Newman was going when they went one wide like that, Gary, to the short side. He was moving up, cheating on that right side, if you will. And they have really game planned to stay away from number four.
They have not thrown one at him yet.
They don't intend to. Timeout is called by K-State.
They didn't get it in time. Delay a game.
Oh, and it'll be first and 15. So we'll take a break.
She always knew the job could kill her.
Said he's gonna see you.
She didn't know her deadliest enemy.
She can help us use her.
I can't.
Would be her mother.
This woman is not to be trusted.
Sydney.
Now a mind game begins. The one woman she thought she could trust. Like mother, like daughter.
You are a traitor of the United States.
Like hell. A new alias followed by a new practice Sunday at 9, 8 central on ABC.
Well, Gary, they picked the flag up, so it's going to be first and 10. Roberson was able to get the timeout called. The officials conferring with each other. Over here, Mark Dunn, the senior, transferred from junior college in Ricks, Idaho. He's getting ready probably for the second half if they get into that passing game.
We can't do any of these check with me's like this. This crowd realizes that they're being very savvy, and every time they try to, they get louder.
Hit on the release. Wallace grabs it. Beautiful catch and steps out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Taco Wallace looks like a big-time receiver to me.
Well, he's got the ball almost every time, and you know the Colorado coaches told us that the go-to guy was Taco Wallace. And nearly every downfield throw has been at Taco Wallace. This time, the ball is laid up. And that ball was put in the only spot it could be.
The Wildcats with one timeout left. A minute and a half to work with. Here comes Roberson, hit on the release, intercepted at the 40-yard line. Picked off by Drew Walruse, that senior linebacker from Poway, California.
Roderick Sneed.
Penalty flag is now thrown.
Number 26 is the guy that got Roberson on that one, coming from behind.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct on Colorado. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Is that celebration deal?
It must have been. Watch it coming off. Roberson get hit just as he was trying to throw that ball. Sneed is coming from the outside right here and gets him. Number 26 comes around. They had a man on him to block him, Danny Morris, but he went right around Morris, hit him, and the ball went right there for the interception.
The first interception thrown by L. Roberson this year. Now, take another look at this. And Walruse, who has played brilliantly defensively, comes up with the interception on the play. And now for the shotgun, Hodge. And Newman was finally thrown at, and Corey wanted to interfere. I'm going to tell you, that is dangerous to come over there. Wow, had he gotten that ball, that is adios.
Really surprised by that. You got a 28-14 man-to-man to the outside. He's just staring inside, and he goes, look at that. If he wouldn't have tripped over his feet right there, he might have gobbled that for a cheap 7 points.
Don't want to get arrogant.
No.
Don't want to get overconfident. You got a long time to go. Again, K-State, two big plays away. They'll be back in the thick of this. They always are. Purify pounds straight ahead now. They'll start to work on the clock.
Bobby Purify,
I remember the Big 12 championship when Gary Barnett ran what? That fake punt down.
Oh, yeah. That was Robert Hatch, wasn't it? I think Gary Barnett went over to Sean Watson and said, we are not doing that. I want to go off the field. He just leaned in again and said something. He lets Sean call the plays, but he said, I want to go off 28-14.
Oh, absolutely.
Settle down, settle down.
They go five wide.
How about a quarterback draw?
Five wide to shotgun. That'd be a good call. Hodge, good runner. Good call, Gary. Out to the right side. It was a run all the way for Hodge. He's got to stay in bounds. And he stops the clock. And is there a penalty flag? Yes, there is.
Now they're going to call this off. The back official called it, but I think he got his helmet instead of his face mask. The referee will pick it up, I think.
The flag will be disregarded. Disregard the flag, no face mask.
All right, now we've got. Now Snyder's trying to get the clock. He's trying to pick up a few more seconds up here if he can. Now everybody's upset.
Well, they showed the replay on the big board, and the fans think he did get the face mask.
Oh, he raked right across it. There's no question, folks. Look at that. That's Randy Jordan.
Gets him on the top, and then does he get it on the face mask? I don't know. It was close, but the official from in front of the play said no foul.
But now K-State has got what they wanted. They're going to get the ball back, and they do not send Newman back deep.
That means they'll go
for
the block.
They send Sproles back, and they're lined up.
They'll go for the block.
10 across that front. They're going to come at him. Mariscal's one of the best punters in college football. Drills it. What a great punt. Sproles. Spins. Sideline out of bounds. Down at the 26-yard line. Is this what college football is all about? 71-yard touchdowns.
These fans
85.
Know exactly what they're looking for. They saw a block in the back and they were reacting. They wanted another penalty called.
Now let's see if it's Roberson or they send Dunn on. Yeah, Roberson's got the helmet on, steps into that huddle. We saw Dunn warming up.
You almost have to take a knee here, don't you? Either that or throw the ball really deep.
You got 25 seconds. They got three wide to the right. They run the draw play to bring the clock on down, and Snyder does not want to risk a turnover here with Wilder, the sophomore from Dallas, Texas, making the stop. And the final seconds will tick away here. Well, if you like action, you've come to the right spot. Six touchdowns. Four of them 70 yards or longer. Let's go to Jack Aroo. Jack.
Well, coach, outside of a couple of big plays, that's been the difference for your team.
Well, three big plays have really cost us the a 14-point disadvantage up to this point in time. So, A, we have to stop the big plays. B, we got to be able to tackle better. Obviously, we've got to sustain something on offense a little bit more than what we have. Some basic fundamental things about getting the lined up on defense and making sure that we're assignment sound going to help us a little bit too.
Coach, will you stay with Dale Roberson in the second half?
We'll find out.
Okay,
tune in.
Stay tuned, Jack. Coach Snyder trudging off to the locker room. Bill, we will stay tuned. We'll be back to find out whether you're going to go with Mark Dunn or stick with L. Roberson here in the second half. Colorado leads Kansas State 28-14. John Saunders and Terry Bowden are coming out from New York next. Stay tuned, everybody. The coach says so.
If we hurry up, I'm hungry.
You are not going to believe what I'm looking at.
Got any gummy bears?
What's ever on the shelf there, Chief?
Can't even tell you.
You don't have to tell her. You can show her. It's PCS Vision from Sprint. They built the largest all PCS enhanced nationwide network. So now your phone can do more than ever.
And I can send it to her. That's unreal.
That'd be my word for it.
Introducing PCS Vision from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
Looking for some real thrills? Presenting the world's most powerful sport ATV, the 660R Raptor from Yamaha. For the ultimate in performance, nothing else cuts it. For a limited time, get 0% financing and zero down on every Yamaha ATV.
Jack Daniel's Original Hard Cola, a premium malt beverage as unique as the people who drink it. Come as you are.
We're here with the new 99-cent BK value menu right now. Welcome to the show, man. So what's new?
Thanks, Steve. There's a little controversy surrounding my tacos. There was a vicious rumor that they were 99 cents a piece, and I'm here to set the record straight. Two for 99 cents.
Tell them about that. Two for 99. Not one, but two. You
the
man.
The new BK value menu speaks for itself. With 11 items for just 99 cents every day. Now you can have it your way in more ways.
Thank you.
Give it up.
Thank you.
The Valvoline Halftime Show, brought to you by Valvoline's Max Life, the first motor oil formulated for higher mileage engines. From Times Square in New York, John Saunders and Terry Bowden.
Times Square, one of the constants in college football now, and another of the constants is you can bounce back from a terrible season. If you don't, you're Terry Bowden, you're sitting next to me. Now, Joe Paterno did not want that seat at all. But last year against Wisconsin was the worst offensive performance ever for a Penn State team under Joe Paterno. Boy, did he change things this year. Paul Jefferson fumbles the ball into the end zone. It pops back out. Zach Mills, the quarterback, picks it up. He goes in. Penn State had a 10-0 lead. But Brooks Bollinger, the senior quarterback, doing it with his feet here. 6 yards on the touchdown run. Wisconsin within three. Larry Johnson pounding the ball. 24 yards. Two-point conversion was good in this one. Penn State had a 21-14 lead. And without question, this Penn State team looks nothing offensively like the last 2 years.
No, it's wide open this year. Last year, it was between the tackles. That's how they started every game. And that's how they were stuffed by Wisconsin. This year, they opened it up wide open with a passing attack. And look, they've doubled their total offense. But they've also helped their running game. They start with a passing game, and they counter with the running attack. Wisconsin, on the other hand, I'm telling you, they have to spread it out and do a better job of running the football. Wisconsin likes to spread it out, but they still want to run. Anthony Davis is not running well. If they want to win this game, they've got to get rushing yardage out of Anthony Davis.
And you know you're having a good day if at half you have more yards than you had all of last year. Otherwise, last year was just a misnomer right there. Kansas State against Colorado. Kansas State, 51 points a game, but it's Colorado that came ready to play with the buff. Robert Hodge looking for Jeremy Bloom, the freestyle skier, hauls it in and goes 95 yards for the touchdown as Colorado goes up by two touchdowns in a game that Kansas State had come back. L. Roberson had a 71-yard touchdown run. He's over 150 yards rushing in the contest, but Colorado has the double-digit lead.
Yeah, he's good, but Robert Hodge, the quarterback for Colorado, a couple of touchdown passes. He's playing so well right now, they are now can contend for the Big 12 North.
And Notre Dame against Stanford. Notre Dame has yet to lose this year, looking to go 5-0 for the first time since 93. Pat Dillingham has to go a quarterback because Carlisle Holiday is injured. So Ty Willingham is down to his former team.
Well, Pat Dillingham is not ready to play a complete football game, and Ty Willingham knew this. He's got to win this game with defense, run the ball, protect that quarterback, play fourth quarters. You'll win it at the end of the ball game.
And if a couple of luck of the Irish bounces, they could use right there. 7-3. Georgia against Alabama. 1982 was the last time that a Georgia team started 5-0. Herschel Walker was the quarterback, the running back then. Musa Smith is the running back now, and he goes 15 yards on the touchdown run. Georgia grabs a 7-0 lead. David Green has a touchdown pass, so now it's 14-3. Terry, a lot of people surprised by Georgia. Others thinking this is a team that will contend for the national championship.
Georgia is the most talented team in the SEC. Now, Alabama is physical. They're physical up front. Georgia cannot run the ball, but their wide receivers are so much more talented than the Alabama secondary. They need to continue to throw the ball. They have two touchdown passes.
Alabama, a probation team, so they're playing every game as if it's a bowl game. Cal, another one of those probation teams, started the season 3-0, and right now, after losing two, they're up 21-13 over Washington. Bowler having a terrific day already with three touchdown passes. Texas Tech fell down big to A&M, then grabbed the lead back, but now Texas A&M is on top with a minute 40 left, 41-38. Kingsbury has four touchdowns in that game. Air Force, they have Notre Dame down the stretch in a couple of weeks, and right now rolling over Navy. The Commander-in-Chief's trophy, just give it to Air Force right now, 34-7 the score there. Kent State against Marshall. Byron Leftwich had a couple of interceptions early in this game and actually had to rally the team back. It was tied at 14 apiece. 12 yards looking for Josh Davis. That's the arm the pros love. And just like that, Leftwich with two touchdown passes and a touchdown run. Marshall comes back from being down to win it 42-21. Leftwich again with 377 yards passing. UCLA against Oregon State. UCLA's kicker, Chris Griffiths, with 27-yard field goal was blocked and set up a touchdown. Oregon State didn't get any points last week. First time that Dennis Erickson has had a team shut out in the regular season, but he gets a couple quick touchdowns and a lead here.
Yeah, UCLA is not a real physical team. Oregon State, they can run the ball. Steven Jackson's run an 80-yard touchdown run so far. They can run, continue to run.
All right, Wake Forest against Georgia Tech. And Georgia Tech, not for the loss to your brother Tommy in Clemson. They would be looking at 5-0 right now at halftime, though. With just a 4-point lead, we're a very improved Wake Forest.
And Wake Forest can stop the running attack. They've got to throw the ball. A.J. Suggs has had a good first half. He's got to continue to throw the ball because that's how they beat Wake Forest.
You see A.J. Suggs with two touchdown passes as well. Wake is the number one rushing team in the ACC. The American League Division Series, the Oakland A's get absolutely crushed by the Twins. 11-2 is the final. Minnesota with seven runs in the fourth inning. So the series is now tied at two games apiece. And it seems like every single game in both the National League and the American League, we've had these high-scoring games, except for that one 2-1 game that was lost by the Arizona Diamondbacks, the defending champions. We'll continue with more of the Valvoline Halftime Show in a moment.
Now this here, that's the drain plug. It lets the oil drain out into the pan. Remember, she's got a lot of mileage on her, but one day, she'll be all yours.
Help keep the family car in the family with Valvoline's Max Life. Max Life, the first motor oil specially formulated to recondition used seals to help prevent leaks, helping your higher mileage engine run for a long, long time.
After our naps, we'll flush the radiator.
Now there's an entire line of Max Life products that'll help keep your higher mileage car around for a long time.
Fortune 500 companies outsource with Kinko's every day.
Chili's baby back ribs. To go.
I think it's going to be about a yard short. Bring it up fourth and one.
Get in, get out, get on with your life.
There's this guy. Oh, it's in my face. Shouting at me. This pushes me. But I love him. He's my coach. My coach.
Be a coach. Be a fan. Special Olympics.
Which of the nation's top 10 research universities is the fastest growing? Where are they pioneering medical advancements and revolutionizing healthcare?
Anything is possible here.
With three Nobel Prizes awarded in physics last year, this university received two.
If you always question, if you always strive to be better than you are, you will achieve things you never thought possible.
Welcome to New York City and Times Square Stadium. John Saunders alongside of Terry Bowden here with the Valvoline Halftime Show. A lot of people looking towards the second half, if you will, of the season. Oklahoma against Texas in the Red River Shootout. For Texas, the tune-up today against Oklahoma State. Don't look past them because Oklahoma State always seems to pull off an upset at some point. Chris Sims, though, having a great year. He goes 55 yards here to Sloan Thomas. Works it down to the 25-yard line. That would set up a touchdown, and Texas grabs a 17-3 lead for Coach Mack Brown. But Oklahoma State coming back. Josh Fields. Looks like this one is thrown up for grabs, but John Lewis is right there to get it. 33 yards, rather, on the touchdown, and a 17-15 lead. And there, a little bit of controversy here. Is this a two-point conversion? Fields to Rashawn Woods? Boy, didn't look like he broke the plane, and the officials call that, and so it's a 17-15 win. Chris Sims, 24-46, 267 yards, and a touchdown, and now it sets up number two against number three next week in the Red River Shootout right here on ABC.
Yes, Oklahoma, I mean, Texas was flat today, but they won the football game, and this was the same Oklahoma State team that beat Oklahoma last year, upset them, and knocked them out of a national championship game. Texas is undefeated. Texas is ready for the Red River Shootout.
It's a big game for them as a team. It's a big game for Chris Sims going up against a highly ranked opponent. He has struggled in those games, including last year. In the SEC, Florida against Ole Miss. 1970 was the last time that Ole Miss started the season 2-0 in the SEC, and Manning was the quarterback then, but it was Archie. Rex Grossman here, 18 yards to Carlos Perez. They hooked up twice for touchdowns. Florida had a 14-2 lead, but back comes Ole Miss. Grossman picked off by Matt Greer, who takes it 24 yards for the touchdown. And Ole Miss has their first lead of the game at 17-14. And then Rex Grossman here will be picked off by Travis Blanchard. And this ball sails clearly, Terry. Rex Grossman was pressured all day long. And as a result, the fans stormed the field against a two-loss Florida team. Just the same, the Gators get the loss.
Yeah, this game was a tale of two quarterbacks. Rex Grossman was pressured all day. He lost his poise. He had four picks, whereas Eli Manning didn't have one touchdown pass, but he threw no interceptions.
Eli Manning also did something his brother Peyton, his father Archie, never did, was that beat Florida. Now, yep. Archie never played against Florida. Eli, though, gets it done when Peyton could not at Tennessee. Purdue and Iowa, big game in the Big Ten. Brad Banks trying to lead his squad back, goes 7 yards here to Dallas Clark to grab the lead, and Clark could not be any more wide open. Iowa has the lead at 31-28. Purdue trying to come back. Brandon Kirsch will be picked off by Adolphus Shelton with 14 seconds left in the game off the misdirection there, and Iowa holds on for the win. Brad Banks, 14 of 22, 226 yards, a couple of touchdowns. Dallas Clark, 3 receptions for 116 yards and 2 touchdowns, a 95-yard touchdown reception that tied a school record. Nebraska over McNeese State, Jamal Lord, 17 carries, 218 yards and 3 touchdowns, a school record for rushing yards by a quarterback, breaking Tommy Frazier's record, and a school record for total yards, 369, passing Eric Crouch. This is the Valvoline Halftime Show from here in New York City.
Hi.
How you doing?
What?
You hungry, boy?
Need a new way to wax? Introducing Eagle One Waxes You Dry. Just wash, spray it on a wet car, and dry to an amazing shine. Waxes You Dry from Eagle One.
How many times is this?
Yo, me, where's the dick?
Only Tostitos Scoops have the bite-sized bowl-shaped design that's perfect for dipping and dunking every time.
I thought that was a myth.
So however you like to dip, there's only one dip lover's chip.
I own this court. Yeah. No, I really own this court. You guys gotta go.
Tostitos Scoops, the dip lover's chip.
The Valvoline Halftime Show, brought to you by Valvoline's Max Life, the first motor oil formulated for higher mileage engines.
Hi, I'm Jim Belushi. Watch my show According to Jim, Tuesdays at
8:30, 7:30 Central. And you're not even prepared. You disgust me. Take a lap.
Just coach.
And get those knees up, Sally.
Mike Ditka on According to Jim. Game times Tuesday at 8:30, 7:30 Central on ABC.
A great day of college football next Saturday on ABC at noon Eastern time. Number 11 Florida State takes on the number one team in the nation, Miami. Then at 3:30, regional coverage. Some of you will see the Red River Shootout between Texas and Oklahoma. Others will be in the Big Ten to watch Penn State against Michigan or the Pac-10, Oregon facing UCLA. Check local listings for the game available in your area. And also a reminder, tomorrow at 4 Eastern time, final round coverage of the LPGA. For more, let's join Terry Gannon.
Third round play has been completed here at the Samsung World Championship at the Hiddenbrook Golf Club in Vallejo, California. And Annika Sorenstam came to 18, 2 shots in back to lead. This bunker shot at 18, though Judy Rankin getting awfully close, leading to a birdie.
Just about for a tap-in, one we might give her a big turn of events at the final hole. This was for par for Christy Kerr.
Christy Kerr with a 2-shot lead going to 18, but the bogey, and they are both at 15 under heading to the final round. Our action comes your way at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific tomorrow on ABC.
All right, Terry, thanks a lot. We'll see you tomorrow at 4 o'clock Eastern time with coverage of the Samsung World Championship. Right now, back out to your game.
Here at halftime on a wild Saturday afternoon in Boulder, Colorado, we're enjoying the Golden Buffalo Marching Band, the director, Matthew Reeder. We'll be back with the second half after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Introducing the Bowflex Ultimate. Quite possibly the best home fitness machine ever made. Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the results you want in 6 weeks or less. Own the new Bowflex Ultimate with no money down and monthly payments lower than many health club dues. Call and ask for a free video and brochure or visit us on the web today. The new Bowflex for ultimate results.
So let's turn to page 7 of our proposal where we feel...
Page 7?
Should be the next page you have.
We don't see it.
No. Hold on.
There it is.
Introducing Chrysler PT Cruiser Turbo. With an all-new 215-horsepower turbocharged engine, it can get you cross-town, cross-country, anywhere in the blink of an eye.
Let's move on to page 11.
Page 11?
Woo!
Saturday, a doubleheader. Florida State faces number one Miami at noon Eastern, followed by Texas, Oklahoma, or other regional action at 3:30 Eastern on ABC.
That was quite a storm last night. Everything all right?
Yes, sir. Everything's fine now.
Westar Energy, doing what it takes to keep the lights on, rain or shine.
Come out to Oktoberfest at Henry Rickard Pontiac Cadillac, and you can get 0% financing on pre-owned cars. With payments as low as $100 per month, get 0% financing on a pre-owned 2002 Grand Am, this Chevy Malibu, this Chevrolet Lumina. Save big right now on this 2002 Buick Century or this Oldsmobile Alero. With over 200 pre-owned vehicles in stock, many with remaining factory warranty, Henry Rickard Pontiac Cadillac is your GM-certified youth headquarters.
Henry Rickard Pontiac Cadillac.
There ain't nothing to it when you let Youngs do it. Let Youngs do it. They can talk you through it. You can do it yourself or they'll come out.
Watching ABC Sports, the class of college football.
Back in Boulder, Colorado with Colorado's head coach, Gary Barnett. What about this first half, coach?
Well, too many special teams mistakes for us. We got to clear that up. We'd be in a lot better shape.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Our Pacific Life game summary, and it has been an afternoon of big plays. Four touchdowns, longer than 70 yards, and look at the total offense. 368 yards already for Colorado against UCLA. I think George Hill told me it was about 477. But how does K-State get back here?
Well, they have to do what they did before. Roberson needs to run the ball if they're going to keep Roberson in the game. If Dunn comes in, obviously they're going to throw the ball, but they have to stop those big plays.
Colorado will bring it out on the 20-yard line. Now here is our Chrysler passing playbook.
Well, it's been big plays for Colorado. Robert Hodge has thrown 10 passes for 221 yards, but look at the scheming here. Number four, Newman, their best corner on third and nine, is standing there doing nothing. And on the opposite side of the field, Jeremy Bloom says, all right, if you want to go man-to-man, with 3 minutes to go in the half, I'll go stutter and go, and that's been the story of the game. Big play passes. Hodge, 10 throws, Brent, for 221 yards.
They flex the tight end, Sipnewski. They open with him, and they open with Bobby Purify as the running back on first down. And he makes his way out just short of the 25-yard line. And Josh Buell, that junior from Mesquite, Texas. Man, we run into a lot of football players in the Big 12 from Mesquite, Texas. Tough hombres down there. They also like their rodeos at night down there. The Bull Riders, hold forth in Mesquite. Here's old Josh, number seven now. Brown comes out a little bit late. Purify starts in that backfield. He's perhaps getting a little extra treatment. Second down and seven now. Little motion for Robert Hodge. He faked and rolled to the right. Then a throw underneath to the second man. And Drum, the fullback, with a first down. Colorado, the Alaskan Assassin.
Thursday we watched over and over Robert Hodge practice this. Fake the running play, come out on the bootleg, and throw it to the fullback or tight end. There you see Drum's going to come this way and come out to the flat. You fake the handoff and Drum sneaks underneath, and that's easy pitch and catch. Hodge is saying, oh, you mean you can throw short too? I didn't know that. You're ruining my stats, coach. Let me go deep again.
Number seven. He's replaced number one, Craig Oaks, who quit. Fake. Roll hard right, wants down middle, got an open man, got him. First down into K-State territory as Hodge on the move hits Derek McCoy, the junior, for 26 yards. Man, I'll tell you the one thing that impresses me is how accurate Hodge has been. We talk about big plays. Gary, he has put the big plays right where they have to be.
He's throwing when he has to, but this time, Brent, they went at number four, Newman, and McCoy beat him. In fact, Newman held on the plays. Luckily, he didn't get a penalty and a completion. Just McCoy beat Newman clean.
Just inside the 40-yard line. Line up in the I formation. Come back with Brown to the 33-yard line, where it'll be second down for the Buffaloes. They lead by two touchdowns. Twice in this game, they have been up by two touchdowns. They went out 14-0. K-State battled back to deadlock it, and then Colorado scored the last two touchdowns in the first half. Let's check in with Jackaroo. Jack.
Brent, Chris Brown was late coming out of the locker room. Why? Because they were filling him full of fluids. It seems he got very dehydrated during halftime. They had to give him several IVs, but he's back out there carrying the ball.
Bloom is split far out to the left. Hodge rolls in that direction. Now he'll keep it himself. Thrown down at the 32, short of the first down by the Tank. Reese, the senior, transferred in from JC in Hutchinson, Kansas, to Kansas State.
Wayne Lucer, number 78, has been pulling all day. He was the center on this Colorado team last year. They moved him to that guard spot, and you watch Lucer right here. He goes opposite the motion and comes out. Number 78, a center, showing his versatile play as a guard now in this game, and he's doing it all.
Now Purify in at the running back on third and four. Remember, good receiver. So they send him out now, basically a slot man. Hodges back, looking underneath. Got his underneath man, short of the first down. They'll mark it down. It was a catch, but this will leave Colorado with a decision right around the 32-yard line. DJ Hackett was the receiver on that play. Barnett has got the call.
Well, you know, Gary Barnett loves to have a gimmick in his offense and his special teams. He is the special teams coordinator, basically. This would be a good time to do one.
Patrick Brome is on the field with a 14-point lead, and now Colorado will use a timeout. So they waste some precious seconds. You hate to use a timeout that early in the second half when Colorado does. Timeout.
Chrysler 300M, the most powerful V6 sports sedan in its class. With its seductive styling and inspired engineering, it is truly a pleasure to drive. Even when that sort of thing is strictly forbidden.
Samuel, is that you?
Yes, it is I.
Now from Chrysler, our 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty, because love is a commitment.
Thrifty.com. Great cars, great rates, 24/7.
They've worked hard to get here. Persistence, performance, strength. It all paid off. So how do achievers secure their future? They do what nearly two-thirds of the Fortune 500 do. They put their confidence in the Pacific Life family of companies. With over 130 years of experience and $340 billion in managed assets, secure your course in life. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life.
On November 1st, Agent Alex Scott will be given his most dangerous assignment yet.
Working with a civilian. America needs me.
Get up!
Columbia Pictures presents Eddie Murphy, Owen Wilson.
Put that on.
You look like a sock.
It's a spy mask.
Hey, man, this is a sock. Get over there.
We're back, and Barnett's offense has dashed onto the field. He's livid that the official on the sideline told him they were ready to go. Kansas State had a few precious seconds to readjust. They were not totally ambushed. Fourth down and three. Hodges gonna throw back. Wide open. First down at the 22-yard line as Robert Hodge breaks it wide open to Sam Wilder, a defensive tackle who checks in and is eligible as a receiver.
You see it. Everybody thinks Hodge is going to come out and go to the outside, but it's the throwback screen. Eligible on the backside. Wilder was lined up as a tight end, and another great scheme for Colorado.
A first down inside the 25-yard line. Now the toss play. And the big fella spins his way inside the 20-yard line, where it will be second down. So here is Chris Brown from the first half. 129 yards and 14 carries, two touchdowns, and yards after contact. That's the most impressive thing there for the big fella.
Well, it must have been 85 on one play at the line of scrimmage, because he had that long run, was the only one he really got out there.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Purified. Check it down, Chris Brown. To the 3-yard line. That was Chris, who did stay in. Terry Pierce runs him out of bounds.
Newman went down on the other side of the field, and I wonder if there wasn't a block that got him way away from the play. John Donahoe, number 85, goes down and throws on Newman. You got to be aware at all time. And he landed right on his tailbone. That's what you got to do. Game of football. Everybody's out there ready to hit.
They intended to. Coach Snyder is now out. And Terrence will come off for at least a play. So while he's being tended to, we'll take a break. Colorado threatening again.
On November 1st, Agent Alex Scott will be given his most dangerous assignment yet.
You're working with a civilian. America needs me.
Columbia Pictures presents Eddie Murphy, Owen Wilson.
Put that on.
You look like a sock.
It's a spy mask.
Hey, man, this is a sock.
Wow, that's pretty good.
I Spy.
You mean like 007?
7-0, I'm going to be 009 and a half.
Rated PG-13. In theaters everywhere, November 1st.
Thrifty.com. Great cars, great rates, 24/7.
Why do your kids only want your opinion during football?
Daddy, which do you like better?
I love all my children the same.
8 simple rules. Join the fun Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
Newman shaken up, comes off, and now Bobby Purify checks in as the tailback. And here comes Purify. Struts the defense. Can't get to the pylon. Down at the 5-yard line, it'll be second down and goal. Tetwan, the redshirt freshman from Topeka, Kansas, makes the stop.
I think that's a good adjustment by Bobby Elliott, defensive coordinator. They put Tetwan in there, and we're not getting good tackling from their safeties. Remember, this team, this Kansas State team, lost a couple safeties. John McGraw, drafted by the Jets. Colorado knew they could pick on him, and they've had to make an adjustment back there.
Too wide. Purify, the lone running back here on second down and goal from the 5. Fade. And McCoy was held up. There's the flag. That'll give him half the distance and a fresh set of downs.
Randy Jordan, it looked like, did he grab his hand? It looked like he grabbed something and the ball was in the air while he did it. McCoy, good size to the outside, 6'3". Jordan, I don't know if he got him with his left hand or not. It looked like he grabbed him with his left hand.
Yeah, the left-hand interference in the end zone.
Newman's back on the field. That's good news for Kansas State.
So it's a first and goal. Chris Brown, the battering ram. He scored twice today. There's Drum stepping up to lead the way. Here comes Brown, battling toward the end zone. Just short that time. They don't care if it's a giveaway. When Drum moves up right behind the quarterback, Andrew Scholl managed to stuff that play for Barnett.
Well, you remember last year, Brent, it was Andre Girard, the guard, pulling guard, that led the way with Drum. This year, Lasur is in that spot, and he's just following. Second, Chris Brown is following Drum. Lasur says, I like my chances.
Drum trying to shake it off a little bit. They might come right back to it. Here they come. Brown dove away from him that time to the left, and he's short. And now you've got third and goal. But the one thing they have not shown us is Hodge on an option look down here. He's out of a El Camino College, California. He's an outstanding running quarterback.
Yeah, and Hodges, Brent Hodges going over the bench and saying, you know, after I handed off, no one checked me on that play. I could fake and bootleg and really get outside.
Great play in this situation is to call the dive and then not give it to Brown. The linemen really follow through on that. Now let's see what happens. Third down and goal. Jesse Wallace. A coverage mistake, and Wallace clears. And it's 34-14 Colorado.
Tight end sneak right here is Wallace. He'll block down and then just go across the field right there. Block down, all the flow goes one way, throw back, and what a day for Robert Hodge. 11 for 15. Three touchdown passes.
And Brown tacks on another extra point. A three touchdown lead for Colorado. Timeout.
Bored, so you thought you'd try some kung fu. Here, it's PCS Vision from Sprint. Lots of popular games on the largest all PCS enhanced nationwide network. So now your phone can do more than ever.
Wanna play?
Give me a minute.
Introducing PCS Vision from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
They even make paved roads feel safer.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Chrysler. Drive equals love. Miller High Life, the champagne of beers. Pacific Life, annuities, insurance, and investments rely on the strength of Pacific Life. And Old Navy painter's pants, the handyman's classic. The Humanities Building here in the shadow of the Flatiron, Boulder, Colorado, on a gorgeous Saturday afternoon. Buffalo fans are enjoying this one.
Kansas State still has two linebackers set back, and that's where the pooch punts kickoffs have been going to.
They're going to say, bring it on. Newman will take a knee. Monday night football, 9 o'clock from Champaign, Illinois. One of the greatest rivalries in the history of the NFL. The Packers against the Bears. The Bears are playing their home games in Champaign. Soldier Field being remodeled. This will be a Donnybrook. It always is. From the land of George Halas, when they were the Decatur Staleys. And now Chicago goes back down to where George Halas was an All-American down at the University of Illinois. 9 Eastern time, and here in a mountain, the best time zone of all for Monday Night Football. 7 o'clock. Can't beat it. Here's a handoff now. Spurs down at the 20-yard line. That's Walrus. Man, Walrus except for these explosive plays on offense, Walruse has been the most valuable player on defense, I think, for Colorado.
Well, Kansas State has not been able to run the ball directly at Colorado. They've had to use the option in the quarterback to run the ball. Sproles so far, 8 attempts, 35 yards.
A lot of great games going on. Wisconsin, Penn State, Oregon State, UCLA. They were both close. We'll get you an update here in a minute. Here's Roberson. Handoff, middle, open. Sproles breaks free. He's headed for the end zone. Only Strickland can get there. 80-yard touchdown. Another big play. Darren Sproles.
Sproles sometimes is so small you can't see him, as Jack Arute said, and right there you can see him pop out of nowhere. A 10-man front in the box that time by Colorado, and they popped it right through there. They'd held him all the way, and then against 10-man front, they go 80 yards. Figure it out.
Bright. Tacks on. The extra point. And it has to take just a moment. And Sproles has pulled the Wildcats back to within 2 scores. Man, you talk about big play Saturday.
Ask a child where they'd like to go on vacation, and most likely it's the same place you'd like to go. A place where families can make memories together. A place where magic happens every day. And no one can take you there like Alamo, the official rental car of Walt Disney World Resort. Get a free child's breakfast with a favorite Disney character when you rent an Alamo car for as little as $130 per week. Alamo, the official rental car of the American vacation.
Old Navy painter's pants are one of a kind.
A better price you'd be hard-pressed to find.
Quality construction, that's our guarantee.
Old Navy painters.
You're the pants for me.
The price
is nice.
He'll wear
this pair.
Wow, they're just $15 to $20 for men and boys.
Old Navy, we are there.
No one spoils me like Mom, but Olive Garden comes close with their never-ending pasta bowl. They make all these delicious homemade sauces, then you pick which ones you want with which pastas. You get all you want, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks for $7.95. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
The best part is that look on their faces when they see how many miles I have on it.
Take pride in your odometer with Valvoline's Max Life. It helps keep higher mileage engines running for a long, long time.
Hi, I'm Cindy Crawford. Watch me Tuesday night on According to Jim.
Hey, she means them, not you.
Oh, a new According to Jim Tuesday on ABC.
It's not like they didn't run into the teeth of the defense. Here's the box. Colorado has 9 guys in the box. And right up the center goes Sproles, and there's no one. Moore misses the tackle. Number 17, who was in the box that time, didn't make the play. And when you have your safety up around sniffing, if he misses it, you see what happens.
Snead. Penalty flag comes flying. We have had plays here today for touchdowns. 71-yard passes. We've had 71-yard runs. We've had 80-yard runs. And we've had 85 and 94-yard passes. You can't even keep up with them. There they are. That totals 401 yards in big plays here today.
400 out of the 750 yards have been touchdowns in one play. 750 yards roughly total offense, and 450 of them have been touchdowns.
I promise you an update again, but we'll probably have an 85-yard touchdown here. First and 10. And here comes Purify. Got the corner penalty flag. They have a penalty flag, but you know what? Let's go get that update before we have another touchdown. John, what's going on elsewhere?
Brent, we're going to try and get this in real quick. Old Navy update here. Penn State facing Wisconsin. Brooks Bollinger down by a couple of touchdowns. 7 yards to Brandon Williams. Point after no good, so it's still an 8-point game. In the Pac-10, Oregon State and UCLA. Ricky Manning steps in front of this pass and has plenty of daylight. Takes it to the end zone for the touchdown. 33 yards. Great cutback right there to the sidelines. 26-14. Brent.
All right, John, terrific comeback by the Bruins in that game, and that's a big missed extra point there for the Badgers.
Well, it might be time to go for two. I always like doing that, don't I?
Let's see, the penalty now is going to bring it back to the 10-yard line because of tripping. And let's see, Hodges 90 yards away. He's got the defense just where he wants it. This is just where he wants to be. This is the red zone for Robert Hodges. Purifies his running back. Purify batters his way.
I wonder if Randy Jordan, number 9, has gotten benched. He is not in the football game. I don't know if he's injured, but he's been beaten a couple times in this football game, and now he's not out there. Jesse Tetuan, number 33, has replaced him.
Well, this is the first time that we have noticed that he is out. I think you're exactly right, Gary, that they have made that change.
Yep, Jordan's okay. They've moved Newman to the wide side of the field now. Newman's down here. He used to be to the other side almost the whole game.
Second and 10. Hodge on a play fake, and he hit backside. Got it off and complete. And a penalty flag. But Hodge, under enormous pressure, that may have been his best pass.
Absolutely.
Hit on the release. He looked like a big-time college quarterback as he hit Melvin Williams. Williams with a touchdown catch.
I think Terrence Newman, number 4. Is he going to get one? Yeah, he's going to get holding again, Newman.
The pass is thrown. 10 yards previous spot. First down.
Newman's on the bottom playing man-to-man defense. He's got Bloom right there. And he says, you're not running any moguls on me.
And mogul this. There's the automatic first down one way or the other,
you can
right?
See the frustration on Kansas State. They're completely off balance on defense.
Well, Melvin Williams was in all over the quarterback that time.
You know, an interesting Colorado. I think Kansas State expected it to be a power football game. They expected their linebackers, Pearson, Hickman, and Buell, to be the stories of the game. It hasn't been. Yeah, Robert Hodge says, I want that completion. It was my best throw of the day.
They've got a first down at the 26-yard line. A couple of yards. Buell makes still another stop. Let's check in on number 4, Terrence Newman.
The game plan was not to go at him. Early in the game, they ran him off and ran him off. When they did go at him, he tried to hold and got beat. And then Donahoe said, we're not going to just make you a decoy. You're going to have to play football. And you can see Terrence Newman has gotten a little frustrated by his day out here against Colorado.
Chris Brown in as the running back. We've got a reminder tomorrow at 10, 9 Central. An innocent woman will go to jail unless one lawyer betrays his client and everything he believes in. The practice, new tomorrow at 10, 9 Central here on ABC. Third down and 8 for the Buffaloes.
Bloom is out here with Newman to the top.
Bring the end around with McCoy, and it was read beautifully by Josh Buell. Number 7 jumped that play. It had no chance.
Still a football game here. Kansas State got a stop. They needed it. Get the ball back.
And Newman this time will go back to return the punt.
Never let up in college. There's so many more possessions in a college football game than there is in an NFL game.
Two touchdowns down. They sent Sproles back with him. Mariscal, been an outstanding punter here today. Drills this one. Sproles inside the 20-yard line. Newman with a fine block. And Sproles is down at the 31-yard line. Top of the hour here in Boulder, Colorado. Kansas State forced to play catch up here. Roberson has thrown for 46, but look what he's run for. 146 yards and a touchdown. And I believe we have an injured Buffalo player down at the 41-yard line back there in the back, J.J. Billingsley. Well, next week, remember, on the doubleheader at noon, Miami and Florida State. And then we'll take you down to Big D. Remember a year ago, Williams all over Sims, and Lehman dances in for the OU touchdown. But this year, Sims is bigger and stronger and hopes to gain a big measure of revenge. Nate Hibble has taken over the OU attack. Tonight, he'll go up against Missouri trying to stay unbeaten. It'll be the Sooners and the Longhorns. Coming at you from Dallas, you can see where they rank in the NCAA, and both of them playing extremely well. Texas was scared to death today by the Cowboys from Oklahoma State. Hung on, I believe that final was 17-15. Billingsley now trots out, and Roberson set to go at quarterback. Moore, number 70, helped lead the defense that time.
No matter what Kansas State does to try to reduce this Colorado front, Colorado says, we're just going to play man-to-man and keep our safety in the box. They don't believe Roberson is going to throw the ball against them, and Gary Barnett says, stop the run first.
Second down and six. Comes behind Roberson. They're going to Sproles, and this time nothing doing because of Wilder's tackle.
Sam Wilder says, I caught a pass, now I caught a tailback. Number 90 right here in the middle of it. Takes it on. Takes on two guys, spins right through the double team. That's a tough one for Kansas State to live with. You double team the down tackle, he splits it and handles the tailback.
Third down for Roberson and K-State. Wildcats need six. They've got almost 10 in the box. The clock is coming down on him. He's got to hurry, got it off. No, he did not. Penalty flag, throws it up deep to the tight end. And Hill has got it, but there's a penalty flag. Thomas Hill.
I think you're going to see roughing the passer on this, aren't you? Or did it go before?
It was go before. There was contact was it really? On the quarterback. Clock was a big issue in this thing.
It was real
it
close.
It was really close.
You know, both the lines and the linesmen threw it, too.
Offside on the defense. That penalty is declined. Personal foul roughing the
there
passer on
the
defense.
Roughing the passer.
15 yards added to the end of the run. First down.
That was right. The zero was hitting just as he snapped the ball. Roberson just threw it up for grabs and got McGee, his receiving tight end, on that play.
Hill makes the
catch.
Oh,
I'm sorry, but was it Hill? Play action. He called it. Remember, he audible threw it, and it took a hit right at the end of that play from Surratt. That's a good call. Held it right to the chest.
Gives K-State a first down inside the 20-yard line. Daniel Davis checks in at running back. He's a whiz. Spins inside the 15, number six. He's interesting on his the punt team, and when he comes downfield, because the punter is number six, he switches over to number 25.
Morris, Let's see if we don't see that formation where they run the option with Sproles in the slot. They have not showed it.
Sproles back in as the running back.
Checking again.
Runs the option. Here comes Roberson for the trying to break free. Out of bounds on the fumble. And it'll be K-State ball. First and goal on the Roberson run.
Roberson checked to the option on that one. And Travis Wilson, the fullback, watch here. Watch him come in low to the outside and block the man who thought he had the quarterback. Comes out, comes in and gets the hit right on Rollins right there. That sprung Roberson. The ball is knocked loose right at the end of the play, but goes out of bounds.
L. Roberson today has run for 161 yards. He has been a brilliant runner here today. Now Sproles, touchdown, K-State. His third of the afternoon, and K-State is about to close to within one score.
You know, Brent, I really don't believe in momentum in sports. Colorado seemed to have everything going for them, and all of a sudden Kansas State goes back down and scores two touchdowns. They, again, just keep playing, just keep playing, just keep playing. I thought we had the momentum in Cleveland, and John Elway took it 98 yards against us. Remember that one?
Yes, indeed. The drive. And here it's Bright. Tacking on the extra point as Sproles scores for the third time here today. Now he's rushed for better than 100 yards. He's at 118 yards. We have 300-yard runners in this game already.
And his offensive line is starting to handle that front. Again, Wilson, Travis Wilson, the transfer right there. Look at that block by the fullback. Drum and Wilson have done a good job matching each other. Fullbacks blocking on linebackers.
What a fourth quarter this one shapes up to be here in Boulder. Jackaroo.
Bobby Pesavento, this time last year, you were calling the signals. Now, how tough is it to be on the sidelines right now?
It's not bad. It's good to be back, though, here in Boulder, helping the team.
Do you want to go on to coaching?
Yeah, I definitely do. I'd love to be involved with coaching.
Talk to me about every time Colorado looks as if they're going to be able to put the Wildcats away, the Wildcats rear back up again.
I mean, this is a big-time game against a big-time team. That's how they go. We got to keep fighting. Our offense is going to have to score some points to beat them.
And, Brent, he's been on the sidelines coaching the other quarterback.
Bobby Pesavento did a wonderful job here last year, didn't he, Jack? There's that pooch this time to Colorado, and Houston comes up for it. So Brian Calhoun, I should say, let me correct that. Let me remind you that tonight at 7:45 Eastern, the Arkansas Razorbacks roll into Tennessee, take on Casey Clawson and the Volunteers. Must win for both teams in the SEC. How about the SEC today, huh? Mississippi over Florida. So it's College Football Saturday presented by the U.S. Postal Service. Volunteers are still not out of the chase, even though they lost that tough one in the rain to Florida. They still got them rascals from Miami coming into Knoxville. First down and 10. And there's the battering ram. Brown.
Chris Brown, the ball carrier.
He's got a chance for a 200-yard day if he keeps it up. He's at 155 right now. Yeah. Roberson does, too.
I think you'll have to have a Newman outside against Donahoe. That matchup has been there all game. Remember, Donahoe is the guy that knocked him out of the game. And I think he's saying, I'll do it again. That's my job. And he's getting Newman frustrated.
Second down. To the thick of the D. Here comes a huge third down for Kansas State. They'd love to get it right back and start taking it right down at Colorado. So Colorado now will just let the final seconds tick away here.
Third and six on the 36.
So in that quarter, Colorado was able to go up by three touchdowns. And it was Hodge on a pass to a wide open Jesse Wallace. His first catch of the year. Gary Barnett had it going his way. Then Sproles broke an 80-yarder. And K-State's right back in the thick of it. Timeout.
The new Jeep Liberty Renegade. It gives you the power to conquer nature. As well as the ability to protect it. The new Liberty Renegade.
Like the game? Love the pregame? Send in your favorite tailgating photo and Dodge might send you and a friend to the BCS National Championship game in Tempe. And you could win Nokia Sugar Bowl tickets just for entering. Go to bcsfootball.com for all the info. And you could be bowl bound.
Introducing the Cheese Extreme Quesadilla. See mozzarella, pepper jack, cheddar, and nacho cheese sauce form a taste to die for. Don't miss the new Cheese Extreme Quesadilla.
Mm, so good.
Makes you want to be bad.
When these cops ask questions.
Truth or dare?
Dare.
Get that shirt off.
You take it off.
They don't mess around. Mm. An all-new NYPD Blue, Tuesday at 10, 9 Central.
So let me get this straight. You make the pizza fresh, and all I do is pop it in my oven at home.
Yep. It's going to revolutionize pizza as we know it.
Really? But what's going to happen to all those frozen pizzas?
They'll find a use for them.
Here, boy, go get it.
Now get a large pepperoni for $4.99. From our kitchen to your oven, Papa Murphy's Take and Bake Pizza. Fresh way of making pizza.
When Dick Edwards opened over 20 years ago, he had a simple plan in mind. Build a large selection of new and used cars. Price them right. Give good service to every customer. To be fair and stand behind everything he sells. He stuck with that simple plan till now. And that's why today, Dick Edwards Ford Lincoln and Mercury is one of the leading dealers in Kansas. To those who don't think Dick Edwards can keep this simple plan working, Dick says,
try me.
Try Dick Edwards on East Highway 24 in Manhattan, Kansas.
Catch more fish. Stop by Fishing Hole Archery and Angling today.
You're watching ABC Sports, the class of college football.
Isn't it interesting how youngsters take advantage of a situation? Here's Craig Oak, supposed to be the quarterback. He leaves. Everybody's down in Boulder, Colorado. And Robert Hodge makes the most of his shot.
Well, like the coaches told us, Robert Hodge has never had the snaps as a number one quarterback. The coaching that comes necessary. And now he's had the opportunity to get in there, get some coaching, and you can see why he was recruited. A lot of kids can play.
Here's the quarterback's down. Third down. Hodge rolls the pocket to the right. First down. If they give him the spot, coaches are asking for it. They give it to him. First down, Colorado. At the 44, Derek McCoy picks it up.
Well, Hodge, just probably, I think he just went over a 300-yard passing game. 13 for 17 in this football game. Very close to 300 yards. You know, 289 yards passing. Look at this. What a game in the Big 12 to come out and do the things he's done today.
First and 10.
There may be number 7 jerseys here next week.
Just take that one and put, you know.
Exactly, a little line across.
Sure. First down and 10. There's a play fake and Hodge on first down. Going to go for the bundle up on top, and he overthrew his man that time. He was breaking Sipnewski, the junior tight end from Granger, Iowa, deep. He had him a little bit shorter, and Granger would have taken it in stride.
Again, this was another scheme play. They had Sipnewski against Brian Hickman, the linebacker, matched out to the bottom of the screen. That wasn't a corner. That wasn't a safety. That was a linebacker out there, and they tried to go deep on him.
Gary, it's interesting how Colorado's passing attack for Barnett today. He really has been focused more at the center. A couple of times they were able to run Bloom long down the sideline, but basically, they've attacked the middle. Terrific run by Brown. There's another third down coming up.
You look at Robert Hodge, where he's been throwing the ball, you know, a little more right side of the field. That's because he's running those boots to this side of the field and he goes left. That's where he's been making it. If he was a pocket passer, he'd throw more to the left side of the field. But Hodge, attacking the ball around. 3 for 4 have been screen passes. So you can see most of it has been bootlegs to his right.
Third down and 7.
Just put a knockout blow on him in that one, number 56. He came full force that time and said, Hodge, how do you like it in the pocket? I've been chasing you all game, and I'm tired of it. This time, they drop back and watch number 56 lay one on him right here. Oh.
Now here's Mariscal again. Newman back deep. State only one touchdown away from being deadlocked again. Under pressure, Mariscal. Inside the 10-yard line, another beautiful punt. Mark Mariscal. So it will be K-State's ball. Timeout.
Tread lightly, son-in-law. There are more traps lying ahead than in the deep woods of Montana. One false step, and she'll have your head mounted on her parlor wall. That's the right idea. Keep light on your feet, and you just might emerge from this encounter in one piece. Good thing there's also a light way to live, the High Life.
Now this here, that's the drain plug. It lets the oil drain out into the pan. Remember, she's got a lot of mileage on her, but one day, she'll be all yours.
Help keep the family car in the family with Valvoline's Max Life. Max Life, the first motor oil specially formulated to recondition used seals to help prevent leaks, helping your higher mileage engine run for a long, long time.
After our naps, we'll flush the radiator.
Now there's an entire line of Max Life products that'll help keep your higher mileage car around for a long time.
Smart move, Dave. Consolidated with Dell PowerEdge servers.
Uh-huh.
Highly available, highly scalable. Intel Xeon processors. Cuts costs across the board. So you're not gonna miss those old servers, right?
Oh, Tony. What did you do with the old servers?
Nothing.
That's our drinking fountain, isn't it?
You mean Hydra?
Find out how you can cut costs across your enterprise. Easy as Dell. Call or go online today.
The new Silverado is here. Now with quadra-steer four-wheel steering, it's the most maneuverable full-size pickup you can get. Silverado, the truck from Chevy.
She never imagined her deadliest enemy would be her mother.
You are a traitor.
Like mother, like daughter, like hell. A new alias, ABC Sunday.
Some of the most beautiful views of the world here in Colorado. And we're in Boulder, about 40 minutes away from the Denver airport. First down and 10 now for K-State. Roberson ambushed. You get the feeling, Gary, this is going to be a great ending here in this game.
Kansas State has stuck with the quarterback and tailback. Roberson's only thrown the ball 10 times in this game. Got to hand it to Kansas State, Snyder, Ron Hudson, their offensive coordinators. They had 9 new starters to add to this offense from a year ago.
Wilson, number 44. You saw the view from behind him. He'll give Roberson a little protection here. The pass. Anybody gets free. Pump fake. Now it goes to the open man. He overthrew him completely. The intended receiver was Taco Wallace. Let's check in on the Big 12 today. Texas survives and heads for the Red River Shootout. Nebraska rolls. McNeese State beaten up on here today. And Texas Tech in overtime over the Aggies. Aggies were favored by a touchdown, and then when Baylor breaks the 29-game losing streak, congratulations to the Baylor Bears. And tonight, of course, it's Oklahoma and Missouri. Third down coming up for Roberson.
He did not understand the play call. They had to re-signal it again. He's going to go right up against the clock again.
Inside of five. You can see it in the upper left. Got it off. Play fake. Going to fire to Taco Wallace again. One-on-one. Strickland all over him. That's fourth down. And the conclusion of this game. We'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. And Chevrolet makes a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
Kansas State was so fortunate. The tight end on that side time did not even hear the snap count. He never got out of his snap. And it was very fortunate Roberson didn't get safety on that play.
Travis Brown from behind him. Low snap.
Beautiful.
Great punt off of that low snap. Jeremy Bloom. No fair catch. From Newton, Kansas.
Bloom
that
missed
could have been the snapper, Gary, who got downfield on that.
Bloom missed it twice. He missed it first, then he dives on it and misses it again. And Vanover, the snapper, comes all the way down and gets the ball. What a thrill, huh?
A heartbreak for Bloom, who was a hero earlier. Now it is first down for Roberson, back in the gun. Down a touchdown. Quarterback draw. Steps out to the right. Short of the 20-yard line. It'll be second down. Moore makes the stop.
Big first down play, though, on the quarterback draw. Again, I still think going back to this game plan, Kansas State said, okay, Colorado State, you told us, you taught us how to give these guys the biggest fits. A running quarterback, and they've gone through it the whole game.
Gary Barnett told Jack Arun at halftime, we're making too many mistakes on our special teams. Well, there's the biggest one of the afternoon. And it creates Colorado's first turnover. Now it is second down. They load Sproles in the power eye. And they get to the fullback. Is not fooled. He'll be whistled down at the 20-yard line, short of the first down. That was Travis Wilson.
I don't know if he went down, but his forward progress was definitely stopped, and the whistle went.
Joey Johnson jumped that play, and now here's your third down. You just keep it in Roberson's hands, don't you, in this situation?
Well, it's third and very short. Yeah, they ran the quarterback sneak last time to the left side. Remember, that's the best side to go. That's where they have their strength.
Almost changed directions completely. And Roberson changes up again.
Usually means option in this situation.
They bring it. There's the pitch to Sproles. He won't get there. Colorado moved after the change.
Bill Snyder.
The Colorado defense jumped it.
Bill Snyder was irate for L. Roberson changing that play that time. Third and inches, and he audibled, and Ninehouse was there to make the play. Oh, boy, was Bill Snyder hot. You change it. Here's the guy they can't account for right here to the outside. They pitch it, coming right off the pitch, right to the outside. Cannot get the block. It forces Bowles inside where to clean it up. That was a bad audible.
Yeah, I was about to ask you.
Yes.
Do you ever audible in that situation?
Well, I'll tell you, if Bill could have grabbed the hook and pulled him over that time, he would have. Because a quarterback sneak moves the chains for you.
And after he changed the play and got back under center, and incidentally, that is Drew Walrose who will have to come on. And he'll be back. After he changed the play and began the cadence, the Colorado defense moved again because they were suspicious of what was coming, and they were able to jump the play. Now a huge fourth down coming up for K-State. We got 10.5 minutes to go in this game, and I'm surprised that the field goal unit's not out there, I guess.
They only have 19 seconds on the play clock. They're going to have to take a timeout. They're not going to get this off.
There's your timeout. Snyder's yelling for a timeout right now. Snyder wants a timeout. They've got it.
They had too many men on the field, too. They had 12 men on the field. They had to take a timeout.
I mean, they were all fouled up. And Barnett's yelling about the timeout call.
Silverado is here. Silverado, the truck from Chevy.
What have you been up to, Mr. Moneybags?
It's okay. I put it on the credit card.
Those interest charges are gonna get us.
Don't worry, it's our new Capital One No Hassle card.
The Capital One No Hassle card has the nation's lowest long-term fixed rates, $0 fraud liability, and no telemarketing.
What's our new wallet?
ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Nivea for men after shave bomb or evolve skincare. Coors Light, the official beer sponsor of the NFL. Cold, down, easy. And the Hartford, always thinking ahead. Well, Kansas State was all fouled up on
Yeah,
that.
They broke the huddle with too many men that time. They were running against the 20, but the play clock, they had to take a timeout. Gary Barnett was upset because it was Bill Snyder who called the timeout. So everything was happening.
Here is fourth down. The first down marker is inside the 20-yard line. You can see it now. L. Roberson's got the fullback. Sends it for the first down. A great call to the 11-yard line. Travis Wilson, the 6'4", 240-pound junior, picks it up.
Same formation that they have shown throughout the game that they run the option on, and Colorado was ready. Look, watch these guys back up because they think Sproles is going to run the option out to the outside. Everybody backs up. Boom, hand to the fullback. Brilliant call.
Now from the 12-yard line, Wallace is in motion. Here is Sproles. Strickland's got him down on the 11-yard line.
Kansas State has rushed for more than 300 yards in this football game against an 8 and a 9-man front the whole game.
Roberson with 171 yards. And Sproles with 116 yards.
We heard Colorado's defense was quicker. We're finding out whether they can handle the option and the speed of Kansas State. And so far, the answer is no.
Second down and 9. Here's Roberson, hole in the middle. And he stops short of the 5-yard line. That'll bring up a third down. Medford Moore and Gabe Nienhuis makes the stop. Time permitting now. Stay tuned for the Thrifty Colorado postgame report featuring scores and highlights from across the country.
Nienhuis is another transfer from Northwestern. Nienhuis, Chris Bound, and Wayne Lucero all came with Gary Barnett when he came from Northwestern.
Here is third and 4 from the 6-yard line. And Sproles goes out. Roberson uses him on a deep option. Short of the first down. Here comes your fourth down play again as Marquise Harris makes the stop.
He must have zero confidence in his kicker or believes he has a play that he can dial to pick this thing up. Oh, it's going to take a timeout.
Oh, my. Another timeout.
Three at the five.
leaving K-State with only one and 8 minutes to play.
Okay, remember, we're just checking out prices.
So no matter what they say, we're not buying yet.
Right. What's running through your veins?
Ice water.
Right. Can't face it.
So with Circuit City's Price Match Plus, you're covered on price.
We'll take it.
Go ahead, take it. If you find a lower price within 30 days of purchase, we'll give you back 110% of the price difference. Circuit City, we're with you.
Nice game face.
You didn't even see it coming.
Now there's a better way to soothe your skin after shaving. Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm has advanced moisturizers and vitamins to soothe and improve your skin. Nivea for Men, more evolved skincare.
There's a place where I get my favorite Italian sauces, with all kinds of pastas, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks. Sounds like Mom's house, but it's Olive Garden and their never-ending pasta bowl for $7.95. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
In 1935, Foxwood Farm started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred, the truck a Chevy Suburban. Today, they have a few more horses. But there's still only one truck, Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
To protect the innocent, this lawyer would have to betray his client.
I can't.
You mean you won't? That must be very hard to live with.
A new practice, ABC Sunday, 10, 9 Central.
Colorado leads Kansas State by a touchdown, but the Wildcats face a fourth down, and they are not even thinking about the field goal attempt here. The ball is on the 4-yard line, and they must go to just short of the 2-yard line for a first down.
Remember, the design of this defense is not to let you run wide. I'm thinking Kansas State's going to go right at them.
They've been successful. Coach thinks Roberson never stops changing up. Here comes the option wide. There's the pitch. In a foot race, won't get the first down.
Strickland comes up with a huge one.
Someone has to tell me why they didn't kick the field goal. I mean, does he have that little confidence in you? I mean, there's 8 minutes to go in this football game. There's a penalty flag. Was that an excess celebration after Strickland unloaded?
Here's Strickland out here. He has to cover his man and react late. The option goes wide. The pitch is made a little early. The fullback falls down, and look at Strickland come up and knock him backwards.
Possession was changed because not enough yardage was gained. After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct on Colorado. 15-yard penalty.
That's what happened. They celebrated that hit over there. Just what I speculated might have happened.
Now, he said on Colorado, but he pointed the other way.
It was on Colorado.
Okay, so he's going to...
They were jumping up and down over that sideline over there. I don't think there's any question. He's gonna walk it off half the distance in that.
Yeah,
direction.
He changed his point. Okay, let's watch Strickland. Got to cover his man, got to cover his man. And then Taco Wallace says the fake doesn't go, and he comes right out. The leading tackler for this football team, Colorado Buffaloes, makes the big stop of the game. Must have been Tawny right there on the sideline. Looked like he got right in his face.
As a result, the Buffaloes are backed up to the 2-yard line. Robert Hodge under the gun here. Safety first. It's Brown. Brown muscles his way. The Pacific Life game summary, Gary.
Robert Hodge has done it, we thought, with his feet. But he hit McCoy. He hit Calhoun. And then he hit Blue. On a game when everybody was thinking, uh-oh, Craig Oaks transferred. Robert Hodge has come through with a passing game that Colorado could have never dreamed of.
Second down and 7.
The changeup has put Newman on the man-to-man coverage to the outside.
Safety first again. Brown battling, carrying a couple defenders with him, but short of the first down marker, so it'll be third down, and Terry Pierce, the junior from Fort Worth, with another stop.
I'm sure Colorado would love to get Bloom out of the pocket with a pass run possibility right here. Robert Hodge, they'd love to get Robert Hodge out. Excuse me, I'm thinking he might go to Jabloom.
Six and a half. Here's third down and four. Play fake, Hodge rolls to the end zone, got drum, almost picked off as he went to his secondary target. Washington had a shot at it. That time, Kansas State did not give up drum.
Absolutely.
Colorado thought they could break him free, and he wasn't there, and Hodge should have just eaten it.
I think it was Brian Hickman, number 18, that covered drum that time to the flat, and Hodge showed his inexperience. That one, he just needed to run and punt the ball. That could have been disastrous.
Now, three blocked punts for K-State. Will they come at Mariscal? There's one lone return man, Newman. So let's see if the 10 will come after him. They set a return. It'll be Newman. Bobbled. And he's down at the 37-yard line. 37 yards away.
This is
6:20 to go. And K-State down a touchdown.
This is where the strategy of Bill Snyder may pay off. He figured if we could get a stop, we'd get the ball back in good field position, and his gamble paid off.
Might have gotten a stop after a good kickoff down.
Well, there's no doubt about that. He must have been rolling the dice and saying, if we don't score, I'll get it back.
First down and 10 now for the Wildcats. Here's Roberson. Inside the 30-yard line, Roberson is closing in on 200 yards. He's rushed for 180. And a reminder, next Saturday, our doubleheader starts at noon Eastern. Ken Dorsey and the unbeaten Miami Hurricanes will take on arch-rival Florida State in Miami. In the second game, you in this area will see Texas, Oklahoma, the Red River Shootout will be coming your way. Second down and short. After that Roberson run, he's now carried it 18 times for 180 yards. They line up Sproles behind Wilson. End zone! Terry! No, out of the back of the end zone. Terry was oh so close, but a penalty flag is down. It's a first down. First and 10 for K-State. A free shot for the touchdown.
Roberson was late throwing this ball to Jason Terry because as he was open, the ball, I wonder if he was bobbling it. We obviously know just 1 foot is needed. He didn't have possession, I guess, because it's the only thing that could have been called. Another angle. Catches. Cradles it late. Yeah, cradles it late.
He was definitely bobbling.
Good call.
Now first down inside the 25-yard line for L. Roberson and K-State. Roberson on a great play fake is upended at the 21-yard line by Sneed. Another one of those fellows from Mesquite, Texas.
This is the spread read play that so many people are rated. Roberson is going to read the end man in the line of scrimmage. As Sproles goes across, if he closes like he does, he'll keep it and get to the outside. He reads the first half well, but the second half, not as well. Still another positive play.
Second down and 7 for Roberson and the Wildcats. Watch on the edge of their seats in Manhattan, Kansas right now. Roberson fires, deflected, double coverage on Terry. Penalty flag comes late. Two of them come firing that time.
Roberson, Terry got held that time. That was very obvious on the slant play. I think it was Joe Swift, number 28, held him all the way.
Interference on the defense, spot foul, automatic first
Touched him right around the waist. Swift panicked a bit. Got the penalty. Easy call.
The ball is just outside the 10-yard line for the first down for K-State. Down by 7 here at the 4:43 mark. Roberson. Draws, pulls, stop.
Well, Roberson has done it about every way he can, every direction, from shotgun on options, on quarterback leads. Most of it has been to the left, but that was that one big play he had. As you can see, they've attacked every different direction with Roberson.
The ball just inside the 10-yard line. Roberson, Wilson, and Sproles. Roberson keeps it in his hands. Nothing doing. And another penalty flag.
Now that was called near the Colorado bench, and that one must have been on Kansas. I think they moved prior to the snap.
Before the snap occurred, there was a false start on the offense. That play does not count. 5-yard penalty. Please restart the game clock.
I think the guard flinched just before the play. Actually, that's pretty good play for Kansas State right there. They didn't get anything on it.
Okay. Ball is brought back inside the 15-yard line, and this will be second down.
We obviously know it's 4-down territory for Kansas State.
Yeah, we're not going to see a field goal. Certainly not this time. The referee, I believe, is going to check the time. He has trotted off, to my left over here, just outside the left 25. There's some communication upstairs, and I believe he can check and see exactly where they should put the clock.
Yeah, since it was a dead ball call, they will go back to the previous snap time.
Telephone checking upstairs now. The clock shows here 4:01.
Anchor Bill Snyder.
Well, a big upset by Wake Forest over Georgia Tech today, and now you've tuned in for the last 4 minutes and change of a dandy between Colorado and K-State. Colorado is attempting to hold on. The official was over checking the clock, and he put 6 more seconds on. It'll be 4:07 officially on the clock. We have a second down and 15 coming up for Kansas State. Again, Kansas State trails Colorado by 7 points.
I think for Bill Snyder, you're wondering if you can run the ball in this situation. You might have to throw it.
Terry and Wallace. They want Wallace as the key man. He slotted to the left. Hill is the tight end to the right. Derek Evans is the third wide out to the right. Roberson's looking. Comes back to Tucker Wallace in the middle. Down at the 10-yard line. It'll be third down and long coming up. Harris makes the stop.
Roberson did not get that ball to Tucker Wallace cleanly this time. You need to hit this receiver on the run. They had the wide receiver slip screen, and Nienhuis right there made him throw the ball a little higher than he wanted to.
Third and 10 at the 10.
Dennis, a redshirt freshman from Louisiana, checks in as one of the wideouts. They're going to go 4 wide on third and 10. Roberson in trouble. Sacked at the 17-yard line. Sam Wilder, who earlier in this game caught a pass.
sack.
First it's Harris, I think number 30, that puts the initial, and then Wilder comes and cleans it up. Marcus Harris comes across. Roberson avoids that one, but he's not going to avoid the next two guys, and Wilder gets a huge sack.
And now the field goal man is on the field with 2.5 minutes, and still I'm a little bit baffled why they didn't kick when they were down inside the five and had a four.
Remember, Kansas State only has one timeout left in the game.
Here's a 35-yarder for Bright. Bright's the kicker, and he's money. That pulls him to within four. Now, will Snyder attempt the onside kick, or will he kick it deep and take his chances with his D? We'll find out. 35-31, Colorado timeout.
New 99 cent BK value menu right now. Welcome to the show, man. So what's new?
Thanks, Steve. There's a little controversy surrounding my tacos. There was a vicious rumor that they were 99 cents a piece, and I'm here to set the record straight. 2 for 99 cents.
Tell them about that. Two for 99. Not one, but two. You
the new BK value menu speaks for itself. With 11 items for just 99 cents every day. Now you can have it your way in more ways.
Thank you.
Give it up.
Well, the good hands people are on the field for Colorado on the right. They do expect the onside kick in this situation. Bright puts the ball on the tee over by the right hash. Terrence Newman, the speedster for Kansas State. He's on the field. They'll try to get down, and they're going to take it deep and take their chances. Strickland will take a knee, and it'll come out on the 20-yard line. Well, now we've got 2:10. Isn't K-State down to just one timeout?
Yes.
They have only one timeout to stop the clock. You've got the battering ram, number 22. Mr. Brown has rushed for 168 yards today for Colorado. You would expect now that they would put the clock in his hands. Here's your quarterback comparison. Hodge has been unbelievable throwing the ball today. Roberson, not so much throwing, but he has run for 174 yards here today. Brown is on the field behind his outstanding fullback, Drum. That base eye formation for Colorado. Hodge will bring the clock down, put it in 22's hands. He'll stay in bounds, and the clock will continue to run. Pierce, outstanding linebacker, makes the stop.
Two huge plays down there. Bill Snyder said, I'm not going for the field goal. Strickland comes up and makes the play, and then the next time they're down there, Marcus Harris comes over, forces Roberson to go wide, and a sack. The Colorado defense, who's put up what Kansas been put up over 400 yards at him, had two huge stops at the end of the game.
Injured Wildcat down on the field. You know, total here, Gary, we've had 886 yards of offense. And, you know, we just have to honor L. Roberson and Robert Hodge here today. They'll be our Chevrolet players of the game. The two quarterbacks, and in recognition of their effort, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
Well, I know what Robert Hodge is telling his team right now. One first down, and we win this football game. We have a running team. We're known as a power team. If we can move the chains one time, we can take a knee in the victory formation. Clock will stop, start again. It'll have no factor on the clock.
Colorado also has a great punter. They have protected him today. K-State has blocked three punts. If we get to fourth down, we've got 1:45. There's your base eye offensive set for Colorado. Play fake and Hodges rolling. He'll keep it. You want to stay in bounds. Stop the clock by going out of bounds. I can't believe it.
Robert Hodge made two mistakes on that play. He snapped the ball with 12 seconds to go on the play clock, and then he ran out of bounds. Even his wide receivers were pointing to the clock and telling Robert Hodge, don't snap it yet. Young quarterback making mistakes.
Third down and 8, minute and a half. Barnett's got to be thinking about his punting team right now.
And Kansas State has not even used their timeout yet.
Hodge is going to throw it. Incomplete. Penalty flag. Penalty flag. That's a first down. Oh, my goodness gracious.
They went with the same play.
Interference on the defense, 15 yards from the previous spot. First down.
Jesse Tetuan right there, number 23. It's the same play Bloom scored on. The ball is badly overthrown, but a panic right at the end of the play. He kind of grabs his arm and slows down McCoy.
James Dunnigan. He was the fella out there for Kansas State who was guilty of the foul. Gives Colorado a first and 10. Now they've got a 1:24 to kill. And Gary can't believe his good fortune over there.
They gave him every opportunity to get the ball back and he didn't take it.
Now they go into the victory formation. K-State can stop it once. A little scuffling down there. The officials will step in. So a tough setback for Kansas State here. And again, a reminder that next Saturday we'll kick it off at noon. Florida State against Miami. The unbeaten Canes, can they get to the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl? They're in the driver's seat. The rest of you watch Texas and Oklahoma. A Red River shootout. Great doubleheader coming your way next Saturday here on ABC. Close out a big win over Kansas State in what has been a wild and woolly one here in the Big 12. Penn State a winner today over Wisconsin. So they come back from that overtime setback at the hands of Iowa in Happy Valley. And Bill Snyder and the Wildcats just made too many mistakes. It has been an afternoon of big play touchdowns all day. They've gone up and down the field. 271-yard touchdowns, one apiece. Chris Brown, an 85-yard run for Colorado. Jeremy Bloom, a 94-yard reception for Colorado. Darren Sproles, an 80-yard run. And K-State down to its one last timeout has used it. And now the clock continues to run here with Colorado leading it 35-31. K-State threatened twice for the tying touchdown. They went for it on fourth down. Strickland made a great tackle down there. The second time they did settle for the field goal, but that has left them within four. And now Robert Hodge, who replaced Craig Oaks, a captain who quit the team, who Colorado expected to start today, and Oaks has wandered off to his next life. Robert Hodge steps in, goes 13 of 20 for 289 yards, three touchdowns, and no interceptions. Colorado, an underdog at home. Coach Gary Barnett and his offensive coordinator come up with a beauty, and they win it 35-31, and now they move into the driver's seat in the Big 12 North, because Iowa State must come here for the game.
Colorado 35, Kansas State 31. The University of Colorado Athletic Department appreciates your time supporting your attendance at 52.
Colorado a winner. And the players shake hands in the middle of the field. Good, hard-fought football game.
I got it.
Let's go to Jack.
Robert Hodge, congratulations.
Thank you.
Does this become your Colorado Buffalo team now after this performance?
Yeah, I mean, we're really excited going to the Big 12. This gives us a good chance, gives us an opportunity to do what we want to do. And we came out and played hard. We had a great game. We played against a great defense. Our team did good. We fought and scratched till the end, and they did the same thing. We had a big win right there.
Do you ever get excited about anything? You've got ice going through your
veins. I'm excited right now. This is great. This is why you play the game.
Congratulations, Robert.
Thank you very much.
All right, Jack, great job down on the field. And Gary, it was wonderful today. Colorado 35-31 over Kansas State. Let's get some more scores and highlights. Let's send you to New York now. John Saunders and Terry Bowden. Take it away, John.
Brent, thanks a lot. Let's put the day into perspective as we head away to next week, which is a huge week here on ABC. The number one storylines, we've compiled them for you here. And first, Tyrone Willingham of Notre Dame, Terry, 5-0. He gets it done with defense and special teams.
Well, I've been talking about, will they have a winning season? Of course, that's the case. But now you have to start putting him in the national championship picture. You got to think of them that way. They've got to improve their passing to do that.
At Florida, Ron Zook, are they going to be trying to run him out of town?
Well, I tell you, it's back to what's he doing here.
Yeah, the question is they lose for the second time. Texas, again, looking ahead to Oklahoma, one of our big games here on ABC next week, barely survive a scare against Oklahoma State, and Chris Sims must prove next week he can do it against Oklahoma.
Their team is about balance, not about Chris Sims. They've got running, they got passing, they got defense. Just go out there, don't throw interceptions.
And, of course, the game we have at noon Eastern time next week, your dad, Florida State, takes on the number one team in the nation. He says they're up here and everybody else is down here.
Let's just hope he's not right, as in off right on their field goals.
All right, it's a doubleheader, and it should be a great one. For Terry Bowden, I'm John Saunders. We'll see you next week at noon Eastern time. Good night.